of course, our national anthem as we get set for action tonight. We had a conversation with Denny Crum yesterday, and we did ask Denny about his situation with this ball club and where he felt that this club turned the corner this season.
I think we had a couple of close losses. We lost 2 points at Tulane on the road when they were ranked, I don't know, 17th, 18th in the nation, something like that. And we kind of, we had, I think, 4 turnovers in our last 5 possessions. And I think that, and we lost by 2 at their place. And then we went out to Las Vegas. That was like on a Thursday. We went to Las Vegas and played on Sunday. And our guys were really focused, I think. And I think the Tulane loss was one of the big reasons for that. They came in knowing nobody had beaten Vegas out there in 59 games and that they were really hard to beat at home. And we went out there and beat them on their floor and broke that 59-game home court winning streak. And I've never seen our team up to that point in the season as focused as they were in that game. And then that was the good news, and the bad news was that was we played on Sunday, got home 1:30 in the morning on Monday, and had to play Western Kentucky on Tuesday. And we lost a 1-point game at home. And it's not that we didn't play that bad, but we didn't play with the same enthusiasm and emotion that we played against Las Vegas. And that's one of the hard things about a basketball season. Trying to get up and down, I mean, it's a hard thing to make those kind of adjustments. And then Western's a very good basketball team, obviously, themselves. And I think that was the turning point in our season, when we lost those 2 out of 3, but our guys were, I think they learned a lot from that experience.
And that's Denny Crum as he talked about his ball club and the turn that they made near the midseason mark. One thing about Louisville, Max, they've always been very athletic, and that's not changed in this campaign.
Boy, it certainly hasn't, Don, and that's the one thing that I find very troublesome as far as Indiana is concerned. I think the rebounding tonight is another one of those key factors, much as it was in that Xavier game, and it's disconcerting to hear Coach Knight say in your pregame show with you that he thinks these guys are perhaps better rebounders than Xavier was. If that's the case, Indiana's got a lot of problems on their hands here tonight. And, of course, we all know that without Henderson, Indiana is not the rebounding team. Nearly 40% of Louisville's rebounds are offensive rebounds. So that's a tough statistic right there.
All right, we'll be back and talk more about this ball game in a moment, as well as look at the starting lineups. But first, a pause for the 60-second break. This is the Indiana University Basketball Network.
Professional interiors. What does that mean? Well, according to Funk and Wagnall, professional means skilled in a profession, art, or craft. Interior means pertaining to the inside. Now, what it doesn't mean is expensive. At Professional Interiors, you'll find the best prices on the best brands of carpet anywhere. So don't be surprised if you find that high-quality carpet that you saw elsewhere and thought you couldn't afford priced so low that you'll wonder how the other guy sells any of it. Professional Interiors, 570 South Main Street in Monticello. The best carpet and better prices.
Beaver Dam Inn in Monticello is the place for exquisite prime rib and scrumptious seafood. Visit Beavers now for their nightly dinner specials, exceptional service, and delicious homemade soups. While you're there, ask about their catering and private party services. Located just south of the Norway Dam, everyone's eager to eat at Beavers. Open Tuesday through Saturday. Call 583-8375, the Beaver Dam Inn.
Well, back once again as the Hoosiers and Louisville Cardinals will be doing battle here tonight at St. Louis Arena. This Midwest Regional, round 3. And Indiana, of course, and Louisville are not the only teams battling here tonight. The other ball game will pit the Kansas Jayhawks, the number 2 seed in the Midwest, against the upstart California Bears. And, Max, they've got a very good basketball team.
They have indeed, and they could have had a better ball club, because Rex Walters, who plays for Kansas, indicated in the press conference yesterday he would have loved to play for California, but they didn't recruit him. Of course, he ended up at Northwestern and later transferring to Kansas. But they have been the upstart team, the team that knocked off Duke, of course. And if you can do that, even though Duke maybe is not the ball club they were in the past, that's still a pretty good indication they're all right.
One of the important factors in tonight's ball game for this Indiana team, Max, is to play a good defensive ball game, because Louisville is a very good shooting basketball team. They have hit, like Indiana, over 50% of the season from the field. And on their three-point shots, they're hitting 422. That's just Indiana's hitting just 425. So they're right there with them.
They certainly are. And in the two games they played at Indianapolis, they were even better shooters than that on three-point plays, hitting 45% in those two games. So they can hit from inside or outside. They can rebound and score from inside. So that's a key. Another key, Don, is on the other end of the court. They love to press. They love to cause turnovers. So not only are they going to play good defense, they're going to have to be able to handle the ball well.
Well, I think from the pressure standpoint, that's the area that Indiana has really bombarded people with this year. There's only one ball game that they played that they didn't handle the press well, and that was the Ohio State game. And that ball game, it was basically they actually had trouble with it the whole game, but I thought more than anything else that was because of physical and mental fatigue.
I think they were. They were tired in that game. You could see it really toward the end as they started to wear down. But they will have to do a good job tonight, and I agree with you. They have done well, but tonight is a new test.
Let's pause 10 seconds for station identification. This is the Indiana University Basketball Network.
WNJY Delphi Monticello, where Charlie Tuna and Machine Gun Kelly are the zany host of Your Good Time Oldies magazine. And it's every Friday night here on Joy 103.
Well, the Hoosiers have come back out of the floor. We await Bob Knight's appearance along with several of the other Indiana people. But the ball club is back out there taking their final warm-up tosses. I think the one thing that I've been impressed with this Indiana ball club, Max, and I don't say impressed necessarily, but maybe a touch surprised, they've been very loose over here.
Well, I have not seen too much of them except yesterday at practice, so I'm not quite sure you saw them today, I know, on the walkthrough, but I think that's probably good if that's the way they felt.
Well, there's no question that I think this that they are a better basketball team this year than they have been in the previous four seasons.
I understand Louisville believes in themselves, too, almost maybe to being a little cocky about it. I think they feel they can handle this Indiana team tonight.
Well, Indiana's had that situation occur a few times this year, so I don't think that's anything new that they'll be dealing with. And let's face facts. Louisville's very athletic, a big ball club. They've got speed, quickness, and size to go along with that toughness that they played with in the latter stages of the campaign.
Of course, Denny Crum has been pushing the fact that Indiana's number one, that they ought to be the winner out here tonight. I'm sure he's trying to build that up in the image of his team as well, help them along tonight.
Well, Bob Knight now comes out of the floor, and we're about ready to get this thing underway. The Hoosiers tonight coming in at 30-3 on the campaign. Louisville is 22-8. Bob Knight goes over to shake hands with Denny Crum, and they're talking over there briefly. And both smiling at one another. And 17,800 fans on hand here tonight at the arena in St. Louis. This should be a fine, fine basketball game. Let's take a look now at the starting lineup for tonight's ball game. First of all, the Louisville Cardinals. Under Denny Crum, a 22-year head coach at Louisville, they started guard with Keith LeGree, a 6'1", 200-pound sophomore out of Statesboro, Georgia, who averages 6.9 points a game. Greg Miner will be at the other guard. He's 6'6", 210, a junior from Sandersville, Georgia, a 14.1 scoring average. At center will be Clifford Rozier, 6'9", 235, a sophomore from Bradenton, Florida, a transfer from the University of North Carolina who sat out last season and is playing this. He has a 15.7 scoring average. At forward will be Troy Smith at 6'8", 240, a senior from Alexandria, Virginia. He averages 8.5 points a ball game. And Troy, Dwayne Morton at 6'6", 190, a junior from Louisville, Kentucky. He averages 16.3 points a game. For Indiana, on the floor for IU at forwards will be Calvert Saney, the 6'6", 204-pound senior from Evansville, a 22.2 scoring average. And Brian Evans at 6'8", 211, a freshman from Terre Haute, Indiana, a 5'3 scoring mark. In the middle, Matt Nover at 6'8", 230, a senior from Chesterton, Indiana, an 11-point scoring average. And at the guard spots, it'll be Damon Bailey at 6'3", 200 pounds, a junior from Heldonville, Indiana, a 10-4 scoring mark. And Greg Graham, the 6'5", 204-pound senior out of Indianapolis, 16.1, his scoring mark of the campaign. They're coached by Bob Knight, also in his 22nd season. And the winner of three national titles as he tries to lead this Indiana squad to his fourth national championship round. We'll be back to tip off today's ball game right after we pause for the 60-second network timeout.
To defend your soybeans against weeds, you need power. You need control. You need consistency. You need this squadron. Squadron Herbicide. For a higher level of soybean weed control, see your Cyanamid AgriCenter dealer. Read and follow label directions.
I nestled into booth 12 at Waffle House when I heard that...
May I help you?
...voice. There stood the most pleasant, caring...
Nice haircut.
...person I'd ever met. Over the next hour, we shared...
I recommend...
...many thoughts.
Coffee.
...about life. You see, I had reached...
Dessert? Fishing tips?
The service zone.
If we could be open more than day and night, we would. We're more than lip service. We're Waffle House.
I moved to booth 11. Oh, miss...
We're here at St. Louis Arena as we get set for basketball tonight. Indiana taking on the Louisville Cardinals in what should be a great basketball game. Third round of the Midwest Regional. Indiana on the floor with Brian Evans, Calvert Cheney, Clay Graham, Damon Bailey, and Matt Dover. Troy Smith, Wayne Morton, Clifford Rozier, Keith Legree, and Greg Miter, the lineup for Louisville. The officials are John Clockerty, Frank Scagliata, and Gerald Boudreau. We are set for the toss. It's in the air, and Calvert controls it to Greg Graham. Graham across the timeline in backcourt. Starts it against Legree and a man-to-man by Louisville. Right side pass goes to Damon Bailey. Bailey circles it back left to Calvert. Calvert fakes, then fakes again. Down low to Madden inside, puts it up and in. Madden scores the first two. A nice feed from Cheney, and the Hoosiers take the early lead. The other way, Legree. Left side pass goes to Miner. Now on the wing to Morton. Morton guarded by Bailey. Outside pass comes off to Legree. Right side to Miner for a long one, and he got it. A three-pointer. Greg Miner's first basket of the ball game in Louisville. Leads it again at 3-2, or should say for the first time. Here's Bailey. Backcourt, jump pass to Calvert. Calvert looks at left, takes it to the wing, brings it back out to Bailey. Bailey drives, 15-footer, no good off the mark. Rebound comes away to Legree. Back down across the timeline comes Louisville. Legree inside to Rozier. He walked all over the place, got away with it, tips it up, no good, and rebounding is Brian Evans. Evans the other way to Greg Graham. Graham pushes it to the right side, takes it to the wing, spins back left, fakes, fires off to Brian Evans. He drives at baseline, kicks it out to Nover. Nover now turns around, looks for help, clears to Calvert. Again outside to Damon Bailey as Indiana resets the offense. Bailey looks right, goes to Graham on the wing. Greg inside to Brian Evans, who fakes, drives in, gives it back to Graham. Three on the way, and good! Greg Graham scores Indiana's first three. So the Hoosiers take the lead back at 5-3, and the shooting has been hot thus far. Back up the floor. This is Louisville's Keith Legree across the timeline. Legree, backcourt to Miner. Miner goes right side. It comes to Troy Smith. Smith on the wing, bounces to Rozier. Rozier kicks it outside to Legree, inside to Morton. Morton turns on Bailey, fakes, fires it back out to Legree. He pumps a long jumper, no good. Rebound comes long to Troy Smith. Smith has it on the wing, outside to Morton. He drives, lost the handle, picked up by Greg Graham. Graham down the floor, takes it inside, puts it up, and scores with a foul! Beautiful job by Greg Graham to convert the layup and then draw the foul. Graham's fifth point of the ball game. Miner was called for the foul, his first. Now the Hoosiers are on top by a 7-3 count. What a driving shot that was by Greg, who was an 82% free throw shooter at the line for the first time and converts the three-point play. Graham already was six, and the Hoosiers are on top. 8-3 score, IU by five. Louisville's Legree to Morton on the left wing. Baseline drive, pulls up inside, and a slam by Troy Smith. Smith has his first two. He drew the defense, Morton we're talking of, drew the defense to him and beat Indiana with a drive to the hole. Here's Damon Bailey, up court to Madden over across the timeline. They break the pressure, giving to Calvert Cheney. Now off to Bailey. Damon in backcourt. Left side to Calvert. Calvert fakes. Tried to drive it in. Does. Fires the shot. Got it. Calvert Sandy, his first two. IU's got a hot hand early. And the Hoosiers are on top by a 10-5 count. In backcourt, Legree goes right side to Miner to Smith on the wing. Smith back out to Legree. Legree looks for Morton, clears it away to Miner on the right wing. Down low, pass comes off to Smith, who turns, fires it up, no. Rebound inside, back up, didn't get it, but a foul. Troy Smith is doing some kind of rebounding down low. He is a big, strong young man. The foul call goes on Bryant Evans, his first of the ball game. First team foul whistled on IU. And Smith will go to the free throw line with a pair. But he is just a 47% free throw shooter. So Troy Smith at the strike.
He hit Louisville with three rebounds, and Smith's got two of them already.
And he just banked it in. Troy Smith just banked it into the... and the crowd erupts. He fires the second one, and this one's nothing but net. How about that? 4 points for Troy Smith, a 47% shooter from the line. And he banked his first one. I don't think he called it, however, Max.
No, I don't think so either. It was about halfway up the backboard.
Bailey gives it to Evans, back to Damon, and upside to Greg Graham, who's trying to break the pressure. Damon Bailey brings it down now against the double team, bounces to Graham across the timeline. Greg drives it right, gives it to Mattenover inside, puts it up, scores! Mattenover's second basket is 4 points. Indiana's on top now by a 12-7 margin. Here's Miner down low to Smith baseline, pulls it inside to Morton, he fires it off the glass and air. Another nice play by Louisville. They're getting some inside work right now that's very effective against the Hoosiers. Again, Bailey up court pass to Greg Graham. He drives it across the timeline to Bryant Evans. Evans back to Graham. Graham now breaking it to the top of the key, slowing it down, looking inside. Greg looks left, clears it away to Calvert. Calvert can't find anybody down low, goes to Bailey. Bailey tries to penetrate, does, lost the handle. Calvert picks it up inside, puts it up, no, but a foul. Foul call is going to be nailed on Miner. That'll be his second. So Greg Miner has got a couple of quick personals here early. It is a 12-9 contest. Indiana by three with 16:08 to go in this first half of play.
Down at the other end of the court, Don, Damon Bailey's just got a tough job. At 6'3", he's trying to hold down Wayne Morton at 6'6", and he's having a real struggle down there.
Calvert's at the free throw stripe looking for his third point of the contest, and he got it. Chaney now has three, and Indiana is a 13-9 leader. Here comes James Brewer into the lineup for the first time. 6'3 senior out of Bardstown, Kentucky, who averages 9.9 a game, and was he some kind of player in the victory over Oklahoma State last Sunday. He threw in 26 to match his season high. Calvert at the line for one more. Eyes the attempt. It's in the air, and he got them both. Chaney's got four. The Hoosiers lead at 13-9, a five-point IU advantage. Across the timeline, backcourt, dribble, bounce pass goes, or rather a four-point lead. Now off left side to Morton. Morton on the wing, back outside to Brewer. Brewer now clears it away. It comes down low, inside to Smith, who pops it up for good. Troy Smith again has his 6 points. Indiana's not stopped him effectively at this point in the ball game. Hoosiers trying to break the pressure. Now it's 14-11, Indiana by three. Here's Calvert driving, putting it up, and missed it, but a foul. Another nice drive by Chaney, and he's upset with himself that he didn't get the ball to drop in the hole, but he had it on the front of the rim. So going to the line again will be Calvert Chaney, and Smith was called for that foul, his first. So Troy Smith has one, and that's the one thing Indiana does so effectively. They drive the ball inside and draw the fouls.
Well, they're doing a pretty good job against the press. They've scored a couple of buckets already off the press.
Calvert eyes, flies, and hits. Calvert Chaney now with five. So Chaney now with 5 points in this ball game. It's now 15-11. Tell you what, you only got one scoreboard you can look at here, because the two end scoreboards are really off the mark. Bob Knight is up asking something of the official. The one scoreboard over here had 13-9 still on the board, and it's 15-11.
That's definitely the score, 15-11.
So Calvert will have one more shot. Knight now saying something to both officials. who are over there, and Denny Crum has come up too to hear what they've got to say. Knight's asking why the two end zone scoreboards are not functioning properly, and nobody can answer that. But 15-11 is the score. Indiana's up four again. We'll have a chance at a five-point lead here. Knight and Crum are still discussing things over there, and Bob Knight is saying something to the officials once again. And Denny Crum now is asking the official score something.
I don't know what conversation can continue.
Well, both Knight and Crum are shaking heads that everything's all right, and they both smile now. Now we're ready as Calvin will go to the line for one more. Chaney has hit his first three tries of the night from the stripe. He has 5 points total, looking for his sixth right here, and guns it home. 6 points now for Calvert Chaney, and the Hoosiers, with timeout on the floor, have the lead. Indiana 16, Louisville 11. Back after the 60-second network timeout.
This is a law firm that believes integrity comes first. O'Brien and Morrissey wants you to know about their law practice located at 1015 Bank One Building in Lafayette. You can talk to Thomas O'Brien or Michael Morrissey with your first consultation free. They can assist you in divorce, personal injury, real estate, wills, estates, drunk driving, and criminal cases. Meeting the legal needs of the people in our area, O'Brien and Morrissey. Call 317-742-9027.
This is the sound of the most dreaded vehicle on the road today, the tow truck. Because when you hear it, you know it's going to cost you. So don't cut corners. Get the best parts money can buy. NAPA. Parts built to meet or exceed original standards. And avoid the tow truck. NAPA. Because there are no unimportant parts.
Well, this broadcast is authorized under broadcast rights granted by the National Collegiate Athletic Association through Host Communications Incorporated, Lexington, Kentucky. It is intended solely for the entertainment of our listening audience. Any publication, rebroadcast, or other use of the description or account of this game without the express written consent of the NCAA and Host Communications is prohibited.
Well, Indiana's firing them up pretty good, as you indicated, Don. They've hit five of their first six shots. That's 83%. Louisville, 4 of 8, 50%. Indiana's already taken five free throws and hit them all. Rebounding right now is a 4-1 advantage to Louisville. Three of those rebounds coming off the offensive board as far as Louisville's concerned. The Cardinals are doing a good job of getting the ball inside. Legree, particularly, taking advantage of Indiana's help-out defense down there. And every time they go to help out somebody underneath, Legree is getting it inside to the man who is being left alone over there, and it's picked up two quick baskets.
Well, Indiana on the floor with the same lineup. They haven't made a change yet. Keith Legree is in the backcourt with James Brewer for Louisville. That's the only change, Brewer being the change for Greg Miner, who picked up two early fouls. Basketball belongs to the Cardinals, and up court with it is Keith Legree. Legree across the timeline, starts at the right, passes it to Dwayne Morton on the wing, back to Legree. Legree now outside to Morton, top of the key, fakes it inside, then drives it, moves it underneath and fires a 14-footer, didn't get the roll, and it's tipped in by Cliff Rozier. Rozier will get the two-pointer on the play. Full court pressure, up court, Calvert Chaney. He'll bring it down, Calvert across the timeline. Works in backcourt, stops, looks for help. Having trouble, finally clears to Greg Graham. Graham now, right side of the circle. He holds, he starts at left, stops, looks, can't find Bailey. In trouble, bounces to Nover. Nover turns around, looks to clear it, goes to Brian Evans. Evans into Greg Graham, driving down the hole, puts it in. Greg Graham with a beautiful drive inside and a nice feed that time. And now we have 8 points for Greg Graham. Hoosiers on top, 18-13. Here's the pass into Troy Smith. Right side to Brewer, who pumps a three. Bob got it. James Brewer with his first basket of the night. That's what he was doing last week against Oklahoma State, bombing the trays. Now across the timeline, Indiana with a two-point lead, and Greg Graham has called for traveling. That's Indiana's first turnover. It gives Louisville a crack at tying or going on top here. 14-25 on the game clock. First half of play, Cardinals of Louisville with a basketball. Up across the timeline comes Legree. Legree guarded by Greg Graham in this possession. Legree gives it offside to James Brewer. Now off to Morton on the left wing. Back out it comes to Brewer. Brewer back outside to Legree. Again to Brewer. Brewer turns around, looks for help. Calvert's all over him defensively. Out to Rozier. Rozier drives on Nover. Tries to turn, can't, gives to Morton. Back again, it comes to Legree. Down inside, ball knocked away. Greg Grant tried to save it, out of bounds. Indiana will have it. That's the second turnover now for Louisville, so the Cardinals commit their second, and Indiana gets the ball back with a two-point advantage. Damon Bailey crosses the timeline. Bailey left to Greg. Graham fakes the tray, lost the handle, got it back. Dribbles it backcourt. Greg now resetting the offense, bounces right to Brian Evans. Evans drives it against Troy Smith, turns, clears to Graham. Graham bounces back inside, threw it away. Troy Smith intercepts, down the floor to Morton. Morton inside goes, and he threw it away. Backcourt, here's Greg Graham the other way. Graham goes to Calvert. Calvert fakes, drives, fires it into Graham, lays it up and in! Greg Graham, he's got his 10th point. Another nice feed inside of the Hoosiers. On top by 4, 20-16. Across the timeline, Legree. Legree just traveled and got away with it. Now off the Clifford, Rozier. Rozier holds on the wing. Fires backcourt to James Brewer. Brewer now holds in backcourt against Greg Graham. Now slides it left. Pitches the ball to Rozier. Rozier drives on Nover. Fires it up. Got it. Clifford Rozier with his 4th point. Took it inside very easily that time. It's 20-18, Indiana by a pair. Graham down the floor to Damon Bailey. Bailey lets a three fly. No, threw it into Nover. Nover fakes, fires it up, and couldn't get it. The rebound comes to Rozier. Back the other way comes Louisville. Here's Brewer. Pulls up, lets a three fly, and go. Oh, no, off the mark. Rebound to Nover. Down the floor to Calvert Chaney. Calvert retrieves the ball. Lost it out of bounds. So Indiana makes another mistake. That is their 3rd turnover. Indiana on top by a 20-18 count, but the Cardinals with the basketball again. This is maybe the first time this year, Max, I can recall that Bob Knight has not made a substitution by now. Here's the pass out. Legree goes to Brewer. Brewer down right to Troy Smith. Smith bounces back to Brewer, who fires and no good. Rebound inside, batted away to Greg Graham. Down the floor come the Hoosiers on a break. Graham takes it right, gives it left to Calvert, lays it up, and no, but a foul. Calvert Chaney will go to the free throw line again. Chaney has 6 points, and he'll go to the stripe for 2 more shots. Here comes Alan Henderson and Pat Graham off the bench for the Hoosiers. 12 minutes and 9 seconds to go in this first half of play, and into the ball game, Pat Graham and Alan Henderson. Brian Evans and Damon Bailey will sit down for the Hoosiers. And also coming back is Greg Miner now for Louisville. And in for the first time is Derwin Webb, who's from Lawrence North High School in Indianapolis.
Well, Don, this is going to be a real test for Alan Henderson. If he can just play well, it's going to be a big lift for Indiana. But he is against some very excellent players right now. And how that injury is going to hamper him at this point remains to be seen.
Well, Chaney has had 4 free throw attempts and 4 shots drop in for him thus far. Misses that one. He'll have one more. So Calvert missing his first free throw out of 5 tries tonight. It's 20-18 still. Indiana by 2. Calvert will have one more, and this one is good. Chaney now has 7. Indiana is on top 21-18. Across the timeline, Keith Legree for the Cardinals. Legree goes left side. It comes off to Derwin Webb. Back outside to Cliff Rozier. Rozier starts it right, gives it to Legree. Legree back out to Brewer. Left side pass goes to Miner, who fires the three-pointer and got it. Greg Miner's 2nd basket. And the Hoosiers suddenly are tied up at 21. Here's Greg Graham. Backcourt pass goes to Pat Graham. Pat slides it right side of the wing, stops, looks low, bounces to Greg Graham, who turns around against Legree. Greg bounces to Nover. Nover inside to Calvert. Down low, puts it up, another foul. This time it's on Brewer. Calvert Chaney has just been taking the ball inside a ton tonight, and Brewer picks up that personal, his 1st. So IU continues to drive down low and draw fouls on the Cardinals. At some point, that may take its toll big time. So far, we have 6 free throws shot by Chaney. He's made 5.
That's 5 personal fouls against Louisville already in this first half. 11 minutes to go.
Calvert cans the free one. He's got 8. He'll have one more shot coming. Indiana has been whistled for just 1. And a big deal was made out of that fact by CBS last Sunday against Xavier. And the 2nd one is also good. 9 points for Calvert. Now we've got timeout with a score. Indiana 23, Louisville 21, 11:31 to go in the first half. Back after the 60-second network timeout.
Hi, this is Willard Scott for True Value. We'd like to recognize the Indiana University basketball team, better known as the Hoosiers, for their hard work all season. When your team is on a roll, it usually means they're doing well. To get on a roll when you take out the garbage, all you need is the Roughneck 32-gallon wheel trash container from Rubbermaid. It offers a locking lid and a manufacturer's 6-year warranty, and it's just $9.77 at your local True Value hardware store or home center.
Say, neighbors, that one of those new snapper lawn tractors I see in your garage?
You betcha. This baby is built tough, and talk about power. A Briggs IC with 12 horses, Peerless 5-speed gear drive, 30-inch cutting deck with 6 cutting heights, 32-inch turning radius, 2-year limited warranty.
Boy, you must have run into some cash to buy this snapper tractor a couple of months before the grass needs to be cut.
Oh, not at all. I just use Snap credit, so I don't have to start paying for it until October. Besides, with Snapper tractor starting at $14.99, these babies aren't going to last very long down at the Snapper dealer.
You know, neighbor, I think I'll go visit that Snapper dealer before the spring rush starts.
Well, back once again, Indiana, leading with 11:31 to go in this first half of play by a 23-21 count over Louisville's Cardinals. The history and tradition of college football, the excitement of the Final Four, the achievements of the best in men's and women's intercollegiate athletics. See it all at the NCAA Visitor Center in Overland Park, Kansas. The message from the NCAA.
Louisville's three-point shooting is keeping them in the ballgame right now. They've hit three of them here so far today. Indiana's hit just one. Greg Graham fired one up early in the game. During the last 4 minutes and 6 seconds, Indiana's hit only two out of three. They've only taken three shots during that time, hitting two. They're 7 of 9 for the game, 77.8%. U of L during that same period of time is 4 of 7. They are 8 of 15 for the game, 53%. The rebounding 6-3 in favor of Louisville. And off the offensive board, it's 4-0 as Louisville has had four putbacks. Indiana has yet to get a putback, but of course when you're shooting 7 out of 9, you're not going to have many offensive rebounds.
Right now, Indiana the floor with Greg Graham, Pat Graham, Madden over, Alan Henderson and Calvert Cheney. On the floor for Louisville, we have Legree, Miner, along with Brozier, Brewer, and Derwin Webb. Up the court comes Legree. Picked up by Graham. Legree, left side of the midcourt line, goes left to Brewer, down in the corner to Rozier. Rozier tries inside, puts it up, block shot, knocked away by Alan Henderson. Good block by Henderson. Here comes Pat Graham the other way. Slows it down. Pat looks inside, goes to Greg Graham right wing. Now back out it comes to Calvert. Calvert Cheney goes right to Nover. Nover fakes, turns around, can't get a shot, gives it back to Greg Graham. Graham inside to Calvert. There he is. Slam dunk. Cheney, his 11th point of the ball game. The Hoosiers are on top 25-21. Indiana's really been doing a good job of getting the ball inside. Here's Legree. Legree on the dribble in backcourt. Right side throws away. Calvert Cheney had it, but it was knocked out by Derwin West. Fourth turnover by Louisville. Indiana will have it once again. John Clockerty, Norm Ellenberger got tangled up over there on the sideline for a moment. Here's Greg Graham across the timeline to Pat Graham, who pulls it back out of there on the dribble to the top of the key. Stops, down low to Nover. He turns on Rozier. One dribble, turns, fakes, fires it up, and in and out. Got it! He got the roll. Matt Nover's 6 point. Indiana on top 27-21 now. Across the timeline, Legree. Legree in backcourt on the dribble against Graham. Goes right side to Miner, down low to Rozier. Rozier turns. Cross-court pass to Brewer in the corner left. Fires a three-pointer and missed it. Rebound, batted up, knocked away from Henderson. Picked off by Miner. Here is Legree. Down inside, pass thrown away, but Webb comes up with it. Back outside to Legree, and he lost the handle but got it back. Now Legree on the dribble toward the left side. Pitches it to Miner. Miner down on the left wing against Greg Graham. Dribbles it back outside. Down low to Rozier. Batted away by Henderson. Henderson gives it away to Greg Graham. Down the floor, the Hoosiers. Graham spins, gives to Henderson. Baseline drive, and he traveled. So the turnover against IU, but a nice defensive job again by Alan Henderson. Four turnovers now on the Hoosiers.
On that previous play to that on the rebound, you could see Henderson's problems with his leg. He just couldn't get up to get a rebound he'd normally get.
Indiana's fans like his effort, however, and they gave him a standing O on the far side. Here's the grade of Dwayne Morton, who's back in now. Morton fakes, drives on Henderson, pulls up, kicks it outside. It goes to Legree. His jump shot's good. Legree with his first two of the ball game. It's now 27-23. Here's Pat Graham across the timeline. Pat drives it to the right wing. Stops, looks, gives it outside to Greg Graham. Greg looking low for Henderson, couldn't find him. Greg drives on Brewer, spins, fires a 15-footer, and hits! Greg Graham, his 12th point of the ball game. Indiana on top, 29-23. Here's Brewer the other way for Louisville on the right side on the dribble. Stops, looks it in, goes low down to the baseline to Rozier. Rozier turns. He looks and brings it back out on the wing to the dribble. Turns around, looks for help, gives to Legree. Legree now goes right side to Brewer. Brewer back outside to Legree. Now left to Morton. Morton fakes. He drives, kicks it off to Greg Miner. Back outside to Rozier. Rozier at the 15-foot line. Can't get a shot away. Spins, gives it back outside to Miner. Now Miner clears it off to Legree. The shot clock's down to 10. Legree drives left. Pulls up on the wing, brings it back outside to Morton. A three on the way. It's no... Oh, it banked in! Dwayne Morton banks in a three-pointer. His first basket of from that range. That's the second bank shot Louisville has hit. Now it's 29-26. They cut the lead in half. Here's Pat Graham. Looks low right. Now drives it right. Comes back, turns around, looks, gives it up to Calvert. Cheney on the move against Morton, looks at left side, stops his dribble, top of the key. Goes inside to Nover. Nover can't find Alan Henderson. Nover stops and goes back to Calvert, top of the lane. Calvert against Morton, looks at right, on the dribble, backs it out of there, starts at left, stops, gives it to Pat Graham. Pat, down to the right wing to Allen. Henderson lobs in to Calvert, baseline move to Nover. Nover puts it up and couldn't get it. Rebound inside, knocked away, out of bounds. Nope, it is saved by Louisville. Legree down the floor to Brewer. Brewer on the right wing, pulls up and flies. Another bank shot, no. This time Henderson comes down with a rebound. Indiana with it again. Cheney the other way. Calvert right side to Gray. Gray Graham pulls up, dribbles it back outside, stops his move, looks for help. He finds who? Finally, Calvert, and the ball stolen away by Louisville. They got a break going. Here is James Brewer all the way for a layup. Brewer makes it a one-point contest. Five now for James Brewer. Indiana, a 29-26 leader. Now it's 29-28. Now Graham starts it left to Calvert. Cheney fires a long bomb. Got it! Calvert Cheney hits a three. His 14th point of the game. The Hoosiers by four. And man, some fast-paced action here. All kinds of subs getting set to come in. Here is Morton, backcourt to Legree. A long bomb is no good. The rebound to Calvert Cheney. Cheney slows. He'll bring it up on the dribble. Calvert across the timeline. Calvert, top of the lane. Looks at left. Drives it off to Alan Henderson. Baseline, can't get the shot away. It's knocked away, but Henderson retrieves it. Back out to Pat Graham. He fires a three. He got it! Pat Graham! His first three of the night, and the Hoosiers suddenly are rocking. 32-28. 35-28. I keep looking at the wrong scoreboard. Indiana suddenly has jumped out to a seven-point lead. That's their biggest. Down low, Morton turns around, fakes, drives it right, pulls up. Kicks it back to Legree, now off the Miner, down inside to Rozier. Rozier turns around in a double team, looking for help. Dribbles it out of trouble, way into the corner. A double team, a five-second call, maybe no. Brewer gets the long pass back inside to Morton, and he has it blocked by Greg Graham. Nope, it was Calvert Cheney. Matt Nover, Greg Graham, Calvert, Pat Graham, Calvert Cheney, they were all in there. Calvert Cheney's the guy who came in and blocked the shot and got the foul call. But there was some real jawing going on.
There must have been something that's happened earlier in this game, because there wasn't enough in that action right then that appeared to me to get anything started. Surely there's something been said before.
I think they may have called a double technical.
It is. That's two fouls on Cheney. That's not good news.
So Calvert gets nailed on a technical foul there. I think they're going to nail Cheney with a technical, which makes it a personal foul as well. And Dwayne Morton would get the other call, I assume. But we'll wait and see. Damon Bailey, Todd Leary, and Brian Evans are all getting set to check back in. Knight and Crum now have been called together, and they're getting the explanation of what the call here is. And Knight now is asking John Plockerty something. And Knight is not very happy right now. Denny Crum is explaining, or is saying absolutely nothing at this point.
The thing that could have been prevented all this, boy, I thought there was a five-second call, Don. I mean, he had that ball a long time in the corner over there, nothing called, but well, afterwards they got the basket.
Now the officials are discussing something. Morton was called for a technical.
Second personal, and another technical charge against Indiana number 40, Gilbert.
Yeah. And Cheney gets called for a technical. So is that's Calvert's second.
Yep.
And Dwayne Morton has also been called for two now.
That's right. You know, that's twice that's happened this year when an Indiana player has gotten a personal foul and a technical right on top of it.
Well, Knight did not like it. Here's Morton shooting a free throw, and he got the roll. And Morton says something to the IU bench. Morton said something to the IU bench. He fires it up. He got his second one. So Morton now has scored his sixth and seventh points. Now let's see what's going to happen here. Now they will shoot technical shots, I assume.
Shooting the technical free throw.
Greg Graham will shoot the technical for IU. Graham has one free throw in the ball game, 12 total points, and now 13 as he hits that free one. And he's going to get another. And he does. He hit them both. So Greg Graham hits those two technicals. They'll come to the other end. And will these be the two shots? Morton shot the two technicals previously, and now it's James Brewer. Well, wait a second.
No, I think this is now
apparently
the
Morton shot the two shots previously, and now Brewer will shoot the technicals.
Right.
Because Morton was the guy who was fouled by Cheney. So Brewer at the line is an outstanding free throw shooter, 88% of the season, and he cans that with his sixth point of the ball game. So one more shot coming here. I would assume Indiana will get the basketball. There'll be a timeout, I'm sure, here. And the shot does drop. That's seven. And we got a technical, or rather, all the free throws have been taken care of. A timeout has been called. 5:39 to go. We'll be back after the 60-second network timeout.
To get ahead, you've got to think big. Your local Century 21 office is part of the largest real estate sales organization in the world. That means you'll have access to more buyers and sellers than the competition, along with the best training and the largest referral system in the industry. Plus, their wide range of real estate products and services can give you a real advantage. They have career opportunities just waiting for you. Contact your local Century 21 office today or call 1-800-886-4849. With the Century 21 system, it's as good as done. Each office independently owned and operated.
In the Hoosier State. State Farm is there, keeping in touch with Indiana families. When you have an insurance claim, you want the coverage to be there. That's why State Farm agents are there with the free family insurance checkup, keeping in touch to help keep you protected. Auto, home, life, and health, wherever you live, from Goshen to New Albany.
And like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Well, back once again. Indiana right now is a leader in this ball game, 37-32, a five-point Hoosier advantage. But I think after the technical foul situation, Louisville's going to get the basketball back. And so the Hoosiers could find themselves in a situation being outscored in that possession as much as 7-2 with a three-point shot coming up here.
That's right. They're going to get the ball because of the arrow possession that goes to Louisville at this point. Indiana is shooting outstandingly well, 12 of 15, 80%. Louisville is 11 of 22, 50%. But even with that great shooting, they have only a narrow five-point lead, and that's not much of a lead against a team like Louisville. Their foul shooting is also good, 10 of 11. Louisville is 6 of 6 right now. So it's been 17 free throws already shot in this basketball game. Three-point shooting, Louisville 4 of 7, Indiana 3 of 3.
Right now, Indiana's made a lot of substitutions. They have Todd Leary, Damon Bailey, Brian Evans, Matt Nover, and Pat Knight in the lineup for IU. For Louisville, you've got Greg Miner, Keith Legree, Dwayne Morton, for the first time, Tick Rogers in the game, a 6'5 freshman, and Troy Smith. So with a basketball, Legree in backcourt. Indiana leads by 5. Louisville ball, however. Miner fires up a 3-point try. Got it. Greg Miner has popped home his third 3-pointer of this ball game. He's got 9 points now. And the lead has been knocked down to just 2 as Leary gives to Brian Evans. Evans brings it outside, drives it, gives it to Pat Knight. He slides it right, looks for help, gives it to Todd Leary. Leary fakes, drives, fires a 14-foot runner, no good. Rebound inside, Nover puts it up and in. Matt Nover with a big hoop there. He's got his 8 point. Good rebound bucket. And there's a throwaway by Louisville. So the Hoosiers get the ball back. That's the 6th turnover by the Cardinals. Here's Bailey and Leary. They bring it up. Leary has the ball. He crosses the timeline. Leary drives it right side. Gives it to Pat Knight. Down to Brian Evans. Down low to Nover. Inside, it's batted out of bounds by Nover. They tried to lob it in to Matt Nover. The pass was a little bit low, and all Matt could do was bat it away, and he knocked it out of bounds. That's the 6th Indiana turnover now. So IU is up 39-35. Louisville has the basketball. Calvert Cheney's on the bench with a pair of fouls. Here is Brewer, left side to Tick Rogers. Outside to Troy Smith, right side to Brewer. Brewer now holds, and a whistle. What have they got? Foul away from the ball on Louisville. Dwayne Morton just got number 3. Dwayne Morton just picked up his 3rd personal foul. So Morton, who has been their top scorer all season, just picked up his 3rd. Clip Rozier will now check in for Louisville.
Well, Indiana's done a pretty good job on Rozier here today. He's got 2 baskets out of 5 shots, but they've kept him pretty much out of the play.
Going to the free throw stripe is Brian Evans. Evans at the line has not been tough from the stripe in Big Ten play this year, but he is hitting 70%. He misses that one, however, and Louisville has the ball again, so the Hoosiers can make hay on those free chances there. Here's Brewer, left side to Rozier. Rozier on the dribble once, kicks it out to Troy Smith, now to Brewer on the right wing. Brewer back outside to Rogers, lost the handle. He's got it back, comes left to Miner. Greg Miner back out to Tick Rogers. Rogers now in backcourt. Rogers goes left side to Troy Smith. Cross court pass to Brewer. Brewer fakes, drives baseline, pulls up, fires, and couldn't get the roll. Brian Evans with a rebound. Evans clears out of trouble to Damon Bailey. Up court to Todd Leary. Leary in the corner to Pat Knight, baseline. He gets it inside, batted away. Tick Rogers on the steal. Rogers the other way, puts it up, and fouled, and he scored. Bailey will get nailed on the personal, and Tick Rogers gets the 2-pointer. And the Cardinals can pull within 1 if he hits the free throw. Rogers' first 2 of the ball game, but Rogers is also a very poor free throw shooter, hitting just 45% on the campaign. So Rogers at the line. It's 39-37. Rogers pumps it and got it. Rogers has his 3rd point. And we've got a timeout with a score. Louisville within 1. It's 39-38. IU on top. Back after the 60-second timeout. This is the Indiana University Basketball Network.
Chevy's, Logan Sports' most popular nightclub, invites you to rock and roll to the greatest hits of the 50s and 60s every Thursday, Friday, and Saturday night. Yes, Chevy's friendly atmosphere, unbelievable lighting, and outstanding sound makes for a good time for everyone. Now at Chevy's on Sunday night, it's country western night. So pull on the boots, get out the hat, and plan to dance the two-step at Chevy's. Whether you're looking for a little bit of country or a little bit of rock and roll, Chevy's has it. Located inside Meyer's Sport Bowl East, 1/2 mile east of the Logan Sport Mall.
Beaver Dam Inn in Monticello is the place for exquisite prime rib and scrumptious seafood. Visit Beaver's now for their nightly dinner specials, exceptional service, and delicious homemade soups. While you're there, ask about their catering and private party services. Located just south of the Norway Dam, everyone's eager to eat at Beaver's. Open Tuesday through Saturday. Call 583-8375. The Beaver Dam Inn.
Well, Well, back once again, we're at the St. Louis Arena in St. Louis, Missouri, Midwest Regional, Round 3, Indiana and Louisville, and the Hoosiers have a slim one-point lead over the Cardinals.
Well, now Indiana has had some problems with their ball handling. We were talking about that before the game. They've already turned it over 7 times, and a couple of 3 of those were really unforced turnovers. Indiana just not protecting the ball all that well. Louisville with some great foul shooting. They're 7 of 7 right now. Indiana's is excellent, but it's 10 of 12. So both teams combined are 17 of 19 right now. Indiana still continues to shoot well. 76% on 13 of 17. Louisville 13 of 25, 52%. But in spite of 76% shooting, they have a narrow one-point lead at this point in the ball game. Rebounding is almost even, 9-8. So that has not been a big factor as far as Louisville is concerned.
Indiana ball, Pat Knight, Matt Nover, Brian Evans, Todd Leary, and Damon Bailey, the Hoosier lineup. Tick Rogers, James Brewer, Troy Smith, Cliff Rozier, and Greg Miner, the lineup for Louisville. And we've got 3:52 remaining in this first half as Todd Leary brings the ball down the floor. Leary across the timeline. Fakes right, drives left, pulls up to the left side of the circle, brings it back to the right, stops, looks for help, gives it to Pat Knight. Pat looks inside, can't find anybody, goes to Brian Evans on the wing. Brian now holds up, gives it out to Todd Leary. Leary inside to Matt Nover. Nover fakes, puts it up, through the foul, and scores! Matt Nover's 10th point of the ball game, and he'll go to the free throw line. I'll tell you, Nover's come up with a couple of big baskets here in the last couple of minutes for IU, and he can make it a 4-point Indiana lead if he connects on the next free throw. Here come Greg Graham and Chris Reynolds back in the IU lineup. Pat Knight and Todd Leary to the sideline for IU.
That's some really good minutes on the part of Leary and Knight there. Indiana's score stayed up there. They protected that lead, gave them some rest. Pat Nover is right now 5 of 7.
Nover at the stripe, looking for his 11th point and getting it. Madden over's 11th, and it's 42-38. Indiana by 4 again. Across the timeline will come James Brewer, guarded by Reynolds. The left side pass to Tick Rogers. Rogers back outside to Smith. Now right side to Miner. Down low to Brewer. Brewer baseline into Rozier. He turns, a double team, kicks it back to Brewer for a 3 try, and bang. James Brewer has got his 10th point, his 2nd 3, and he is tough. It's 42-41. The lead's back down to just 1 for IU. Reynolds to Brian Evans. Evans outside. Back to Greg Graham. A 3 on the way. Short. Rebound comes away to Tick Rogers. Rogers comes back down the floor for Louisville. Cardinals could come up and take the lead here. Here is Miner. Down baseline to Smith. Troy Smith outside to Brewer. Brewer against Reynolds. Inside to Rozier. Rozier back out to Tick Rogers. A 3 on the way. He missed it. And the rebound comes off to Chris Reynolds. Down the floor to Damon Bailey. Bailey now, right side of the circle. Fakes, drives right, gives to Brian Evans. Evans back outside to Chris. Reynolds looks, can't find anybody. Backs it out on the dribble. Chris drives it right, gives it off to Damon. Damon down inside the lane. Jump shot is up and no good. Troy Smith with the rebound, and Louisville's back in the attack. Here's Brewer. Brewer takes it left side, pulls up, fires, and missed it short. Rebound batted away. Bailey's got it. Damon up the court. 3-on-2. Damon inside to Greg Graham. Slam dunk! Greg Graham, 16 points. 44-41. IU by 3. 1:56 to go in the half. The Hoosiers trying to hang on to that lead. Here's Brewer. Bounces left side. It comes to Legree outside, or Miner rather, to Brewer. Now right side to Rogers. Rogers holds on the wing. Inside to Troy Smith. Back to Rogers. Now out to Miner. Left side to Brewer. 3 on the way. No good this time. Rebound Matt Nover for Indiana. He clears off to Chris Reynolds. Reynolds across the timeline. Reynolds left side to Brian Evans. Evans holds. On the dribble, Brian takes it right, spins left, gives to Greg Graham. Graham, outside pass to Reynolds. Chris, left side to Damon. Bailey, back out to Evans. Evans, top of the key, left side to Bailey. 3 on the way by Damon. Good! Damon Bailey, his first 3-pointer and his first points of this game, and they couldn't be bigger. The Hoosier lead is back to 6 at 47-41. Now, the Hoosier crowd on its feet. Across the timeline will come Brewer. Brewer, left side pass to Smith. Troy Smith holds outside to Rozier. Rozier drives on Nover, puts it up and got it. Rozier, A quick move to the hole for his 6 points. Nats 47-43. The Hoosier lead is 6. And they have the basketball. Actually, it's 4. And they will try to take probably the last shot of the half. The ball only 1 second differentiates between the time clock and the game clock. Here's Bryant Evans holding on to it. Down to 24. Bryant holds on. Nobody's guarding him, so he just hangs onto the basketball. Shot clock's down to 16. Now he gives the ball to Reynolds. Chris starts the offense. 12, 11. And here's an offensive foul call on Chris Reynolds. Reynolds gets nailed on his first foul. So the Hoosiers need a stop with 9.6 seconds to go in the first half. 47-43 count. The Hoosiers by 4. Into the game. Here comes Brewer across the timeline in a hurry. Left side pass stolen away by Nover. Big and Brian Evans. And out of bounds. It is Indiana ball. Bryant Evans with some great defensive work there. And 1.9 seconds on the clock. Here comes Todd Leary in the game. Leary checks in for Reynolds. So you got Bailey, Reynolds, Greg Graham, Matt Nover, and Bryant Evans. Bryant Evans will inbound. Evans looks, gets it to Bailey. Damon fires a three. Yes! To the ball game at halftime. What a clutch shot by Bailey. His second three in the last minute. And Indiana leads at 40, or make it 50-43 at halftime here at the St. Louis Arena in St. Louis, Missouri. We'll be back with our halftime show after this 60-second break for a network timeout.
Okay, there are certain things I want to know.
Mom, look what Chip put in his mouth.
And certain things I wish I didn't know. Now, how much do I really need to know about drying clothes?
How much money do you want to save? Natural gas is the ideal energy.
Do you remember those cold nights when you used to haul in firewood and make strange growling noises when you tried to light the fire? Do you miss it?
I kind of miss the growling noises. Natural gas fireplaces are warm, clean, and efficient. Natural gas is the ideal energy.
Gee, this pot roast is great. It tastes different.
Yeah, I use beef instead of bologna.
Oh, a touch of extravagance, my pet.
Yeah, we can afford it now that we're cooking with gas.
Today's technology means you're cooking for less with natural gas, the ideal energy. For new information on today's natural gas technology and the ideal energy, call Indiana Gas at 1-800-777-4414.
Well, back once again at St. Louis Arena in St. Louis, Missouri, where the house is buzzing, where Indiana takes a 7-point lead at halftime, and what a shot with 1.9 seconds to go. The inbound pass from Bryant Evans to Damon Bailey. He wheels, fires, and drills a tray that gives the Hoosiers their 7-point lead at the break. It is 50-43, Indiana. Let's look at the individual scoring in the first half of this ball game. First of all, for Louisville, Keith Legree has a field goal for 2 points, no fouls. Greg Miter has 3 trays, 9 points, and 2 personals. Cliff Rozier, 3 field goals, 6 points, no fouls. Troy Smith with a pair of field goals, a pair of free throws, 6 points, and 1 foul. Dwayne Morton has fired in 7 first-half points. On a 3-point field goal, a regular field goal, and 2 free throws, 7 points, and 3 personals on Dwayne Morton. James Brewer has popped for 3 field goals. 2 of them have been 3-pointers, a regular field goal, and 2 free throws. 10 points for James Brewer and 1 foul. Derwin Webb did not score or foul in brief play. Tick Rogers has a field goal and a free throw for 3 points at halftime, and he did not pick up a foul. For Indiana, Chris Reynolds, no points, 1 foul. Damon Bailey, 2 field goals, both 3-pointers, both in the last couple of moments of the first half, and the last one was huge. 6 points for Damon and no fouls. Matt Nover has 5 field goals, a free throw for 11 first-half points and no fouls. Calvert Chaney has gunned home three field goals, one of them a three-pointer. He's also tossed in seven free throws, and Calvert has 14 first-half points to go along with two personal fouls. Alan Henderson, no points, no fouls. Greg Graham fired in five field goals, making six field goals in the first half, a three-pointer among them, and three free throws, 16 first-half points for Greg Graham. Brian Evans did not score, has one foul. Pat Graham has 1 3-point field goal for 3 points and no fouls. Todd Leary and Pat Knight played, did not score or foul. So Indiana being led by Calvert Chaney and Greg Graham. Graham with 16, Chaney with 14, and Matt Nover with 11, while Louisville, at this point, has nobody in double figures. 9 points for Greg Miter to lead their scoring. Max, look at those team stats.
Well, Don, the Indiana shooting is absolutely fantastic. 17 out of 23, that's 73.9%. Outstanding. Louisville's not bad, but they're only shooting 50%. 15 of 30. They have put up seven more shots than Indiana, two less baskets. Both teams shooting three-point shots fairly well. Indiana outstandingly well, 5 of 6. Greg Graham has missed the only three-point shot Indiana has missed tonight. Louisville is 6 of 11, 54.4. Free throws, Louisville is perfect, 7 of 7. Indiana is 11 of 13, 84%. So that is outstanding shooting on the part of both teams. Rebounding, surprisingly, at least to me, dead even. 11 rebounds for both. Nover has 3 to lead Indiana. Rozier has 4 for the Louisville Cardinals. Both teams with exactly the same number of turnovers. 8. The point run so far, Indiana's had 2 7-point leads in this game. 3, actually, including the one they have right now. Evans has 4 assists in this game already. Legree has 4 off the bench. Louisville has a 13-3 advantage over Indiana, and points off turnovers, Indiana is a 10-7 leader. Well, Chaney is perfect from the field, 3 of 3. Nover is 5 of 7. Graham is 5 of 7. Damon Bailey is 6 of 7. Damon Bailey is 2 of 4. Bailey had missed all 4 three-point shots he took in Indianapolis in those two games. He's perfect tonight on three-point shots. Leary has missed his only shot. Pat Graham has hit his only a three-point shot. Right now, Jim Brewer, who had those 26 points in that game against Oklahoma State for Louisville, is 3 for 10 in this first game.
All right, our halftime score, Indiana 50, Louisville 43. Back with our halftime guest, Jim Main, a former Big Ten official. After we pause for the 60-second break, this is the Indiana University Basketball Network.
Logan Sport Ford Lincoln Mercury, the affordability store, has the number one best-selling car in America. Plus, they have the number one best-selling truck in America. At Logan Sport Ford Lincoln Mercury has great selection, a pleasant atmosphere, affordable quality service, and guaranteed no high pressure. Their goal at Logan Sport Ford Lincoln Mercury is your total satisfaction. Nobody makes it more affordable than the Logan Sport Ford Lincoln Mercury store, located at the east end of the Logan Sport Mall.
A law firm that believes integrity comes first. O'Brien and Morrissey wants you to know about their law practice located at 1015 Bank One Building in Lafayette. You can talk to Thomas O'Brien or Michael Morrissey with your first consultation free. They can assist you in divorce, personal injury, real estate, wills, estates, drunk driving, and criminal cases. Meeting the legal needs of the people in our area, O'Brien and Morrissey. Call 317-742-9027.
Indiana leads the Louisville Cardinals at halftime 50-43. Well, making the right moves is a game that takes quick thinking. And if you can't think fast or move fast without a clear head, or if you use drugs, make the right move, the smart move. Ask for help. Don't use drugs. This message from the NCAA. Let's pause 10 seconds for station identification. This is the Indiana University Basketball Network.
WNJY, Delphi, Monticello, where we keep you up to date with a half hour of farm news every morning before 6 o'clock here on Joy 103.
Well, here at the St. Louis Arena, Indiana up by 7 points, and we do have Jim Bain seated alongside us. Jim, a longtime Big Ten official and now currently supervisor of officials for the Missouri Valley. And Jim, I guess the officials have been involved in some interesting calls here in this first half, in which we got some little discussions going on, and they had to call a couple of technicals. Yeah. They handled it very well.
Yeah, they've done a very good job, Max. In the first half, there were some unique things that don't happen very often. This year, there's been an emphasis by the NCAA on baiting and pawning, and we had a play situation where that occurred, and John Clogarty addressed it, got the two players apart, and assessed the penalties and handled it exactly correct.
The only thing he missed on a five-second call. It would have avoided the whole thing, but that's, of course, that's the way I saw it. But at any rate, it has been an outstanding first half. What were your thoughts on this first half?
Well, anytime you put the basketball teams on the floor at this level of competition, when you get to regional, it's exciting experience, and you know that you're going to have a great game of basketball because our athletes today are so skillful, so strong, so agile, and so full of speed and energy that it's an exciting game to watch.
Jim, did you enjoy getting into the NCAA, and was that lots more exciting for you than your routine games?
Oh, absolutely. You know, officials have goals just like teams and players and coaches do, and it's always a goal of any official that works at the Division I level to be chosen to officiate in the NCAA postseason tournament. So, yes. Every year when you walk on the ball, on the basketball floor in November, that's your goal, is to be chosen to officiate the NCAA tournament. It's always the epitome of officiating.
Jim, I'm going to come back and talk to you a little bit about your experiences in the Big Ten. Right now, I need to pause 60 seconds. This is the Indiana University Basketball Network.
Professional interiors. What does that mean? Well, according to Funk and Wagnall, professional means skilled in a profession, art, or craft. Interior means pertaining to the inside. Now, what it doesn't mean is expensive. At Professional Interiors, you'll find the best prices on the best brands of carpet anywhere. So don't be surprised if you find that high-quality carpet that you saw elsewhere and thought you couldn't afford priced so low that you'll wonder how the other guy sells any of it. Professional Interiors, 570 South Main Street in Monticello. The best carpet and best prices.
Goody Sports Center is always bleeding red for the Indiana Hoosiers, and they'll bleed red for you too. Goody Sports Center, located in downtown Monticello, is your total sporting goods headquarters, even if your favorite colors aren't red and white. If it has anything to do with sports, Goody's has it. Whether it's shoes, sweats, jackets, or any kind of sports equipment, you can get it at Goody Sports Center. Goody's, located in the Shoppers Concourse, 103 South Main in downtown Monticello. Call 583-3009.
First round of the regional of the NCAA tourney here in St. Louis, and Indiana leads Louisville at halftime, 50-43. We're talking with Jim Payne, who is now supervisor of officials for the Missouri Valley Conference, but used to referee in the Big Ten as we saw him move from game to game. Jim, you had a great experience, I suppose, the Big Ten. What was your relationship with Coach Knight?
Well, I think Coach Knight and I had a very good relationship. I always had a great deal of respect for his coaching ability and his coaching talent, and hopefully I think he had some respect for my officiating ability. And while on occasions we had a confrontation or two, I think we mutually admired one another, and it was a great relationship, and I value it today.
He always seems to have something to say to the officials before the game. Did he always talk to you, too?
Oh, absolutely. You know, I've often told the story that Coach Knight's an Everett lost for words, and at one night in a December game, I made a call, and he said something critical to me, and I turned around, and I said, Coach, I said, you better be quiet or I'll bite your head off. And never being at a loss for words, he looked at me, and he said, Bane, if you do, there's one thing for sure. You'll have more brains in your stomach than you got in your hand. One of my fellow officials wanted to know why I didn't call a technical foul. I said, I'm not going to penalize honesty.
That's all right. Do you feel that the officials should talk to the coaches or walk away from them? You know, they seem to react both ways with some success.
Well, I feel very strongly, Max, that communication is a characteristic of a successful official. And I think that successful official who knows how to communicate knows when to communicate and when not to. I've always said there's time on the floor whenever you deal with things as far as sugar and the spice is concerned. There's a time like in the first half when the officials had to be firm. But yes, I think communication is a valuable asset to the official, but he's got to know when to walk away and let the coach cool down.
What are your duties here, Jim? Do you have any specific duties here tonight?
Well, my primary responsibility here this evening is to see that our national coordinator, Hank Nichols, is taken care of and to take care of our officials, to see that they're properly cared for as far as their dressing facilities. And that's my responsibility, and I'm very happy to do it.
How many years were you in the Big Ten?
I was in the Big Ten for 25 years, and I enjoyed every year of it. The Big Ten is a fantastic conference, and I thoroughly enjoyed my association with all the institutions, but especially enjoyed always coming over to the Indiana and working for the Hoosiers.
Jim, we appreciate your stopping by and visiting with us here at halftime. I'm sure we're going to be in for another exciting half.
Oh, I'm sure we will, and good luck to you.
Thank you very much. Jim Bain visiting with us here at halftime. As I mentioned, he is supervisor for the Missouri Valley officials and formerly with the Big Ten. Well, both teams have returned to the playing court. The official stats, as we gave you earlier, Indiana 17 of 23, 73.9%. Louisville 15 of 30, 50%. Louisville 6 of 11, 3-point range, 54.5. Indiana 5 of 6, 83.3. From the foul line, 7 of 7 for Louisville, 11 of 13 for Indiana. So, Don, the Hoosiers have a 7-point lead, but they've had three of them, and it doesn't take long for that to get wiped away, but we're going to go at it again for another 20 minutes.
Well, D-Dance Gentlemen and Ladies Clothier of Indianapolis want to join the thousands of Hoosier fans all across the state in congratulating Indiana University's basketball team on winning the Big Ten Championship and wishing them all the best in their quest for the 1993 NCAA title. D-Dance is open daily Monday through Saturday from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. and on Wednesday and Thursday open till 9. D-Dance Clothing to complement your lifestyle and at West 86th Street at Township Line Road in the North Fulham Mall in Indianapolis. Back with the start of the second half after we pause for the 60-second network timeout.
Here's a tax tip from the Indiana CPA Society. Don't assume that an IRA account no longer holds any tax benefits for you. If you're not covered by a retirement plan at work, you can make a tax-deductible IRA contribution of up to $2,000 if you're single or $4,000 if you're married. And even if you are covered by a retirement plan, you may still be able to make a deductible IRA contribution, depending on your adjusted gross income. A certified public accountant can provide the details for you on this and other tax or business matters. CPAs make a difference.
What's clear?
New Crystal Clear Amoco Ultimate Gasoline.
What isn't?
All other premium gasolines.
What's clear?
New Improved Amoco Ultimate is the only premium refined an extra step to remove harmful impurities called PNAs.
PNAs?
Impurities that can rob your engine of performance and contribute to hydrocarbon exhaust emissions.
What's clear?
For unsurpassed performance in a cleaner environment, Crystal Clear Amoco Ultimate.
New in this area.
You expect more from a leader.
Once again here at St. Louis Arena, as we're about to get the second half of this ball game underway, Indiana 50, Louisville 43, a phenomenal first half shooting performance by IU, and the scary thing about that is they're just up 7.
That is right. Louisville has won only 3 and lost 6 when they've trailed at halftime through the year, for those of you interested in that kind of information.
Bailey will inbound for IU to Greg Graham, along with Calvert Cheney, Matt Nover, and Brian Evans, the original starting five for IU. Same story for Louisville. Here's Graham at backcourt on the move. Takes it toward the right side. Pulls up, gives to Bailey. Damon back out to Calvert. Calvert backs it out on the dribble. Looks at left side. Top of the key, gives it right to Greg Graham. Graham holds, looks, then dribbles it, gives to Matt Nover. Nover looks it inside, lost the handle, and Matt Nover is going to be called for a foul. So Nover gets called for the personal after Dwayne Morton stole it from him. So Indiana turns it over. The Cardinals will have the ball. That's Indiana's 9th turnover. The turnovers were exactly the same for the two ball clubs in the first half. The rebounds were exactly the same. Indiana's hot shooting hand was the difference. Here's a bounce pass. Rozier in backcourt holds. Lobs it down low for Morton. Inside, puts it up, missed the shot. Rebound batted away. Troy Smith has got it, and he is fouled. Foul call goes against IU. And they're going to nail Matt Nover. That's his second. So Nover picks up two quick ones here to start the second half. And Troy Smith, The 6'8 senior out of Alexandria, Virginia, will go to the line. He's 2 for 2 today from the stripe. 6 points in the first half of play. Southpaw is not very good from the line percentage-wise. And that one bounces high off the rim and does not fall. That's his first miss, however. He's 2 for 3 now. And that's the first miss for Louisville from the line, and he missed them both. The rebound, Calvert Cheney for IU. Up court to Greg Graham. Graham across the timeline, drives it left side against Legree, forces it up, no, but a foul on Legree. Keith Legree called for his first foul of the ball game. Indiana continues to drive inside and try to get Louisville in foul trouble. At the stripe will be Graham, who has 16 first half points, looking for his first points of the second half. From the line, he has hit 3 out of 3. Greg fires this one up, and he got it. Greg Graham now has 17. He has one more shot coming. He'll try to open that lead up to 9 if he can convert number 2. The Hoosiers enjoying their biggest margin of the game, and he cans it. 18 now for Greg Graham. Up the court comes Louisville. Here is Legree in backcourt. Left side pass to Dwayne Morton. Morton looks in, comes out to Rozier. Rozier drives, fires it up. No good. Rebound, Brian Evans. Evans clears away to Greg Graham. Graham across the timeline. Graham slides it left, pulls it back out, gives it to Bailey. Bailey down in the lane. Back to Greg Graham for a 3-try, and it's no good. Rebound pulled out of there by Greg Miner. Fast break pass goes to Morton. He lays it up and missed it, and a foul. Greg Graham is saying he did not do anything to him. The official says he undercut it. Dwayne Morton is called for the personal, or rather, Greg Graham is called for the personal. That's his first of the ball game, and Greg didn't like the call at all. But it does no good as Morton will go to the line. Morton has 7 points in the first half, looking for his first points of the second. And so Morton at the line, as Indiana leads by 9, will try to cut it back down to 7. Morton, a good free throw shooter at 74% of the season, averaging 16.3 points a ball game, and he missed that one badly. Hit the front of the limb and went to the left. He'll have one more. Morton eyes number 2. It is up and it is good. Morton now with his 8th point of the contest. It's now 52-44. Indiana by 8. Greg Graham with the basketball. Graham, top of the key. Backs it back out. Sets up the offense. Graham now stops, gives to Bailey. Bailey tries to drive it right. Pulls up on the wing. Gets it out to Calvert. Batted away, but Calvert retrieves it. Gives it to Bailey. Damon down low to Nover. Nover turns on Hopgood, who's back in. For the first time, John Hopgood's in. Here's Evans out to Greg Graham. Back in the corner to Brian Evans. Fakes, drives, fakes down low to Calvert. The ball batted out of bounds by Legree. It'll belong to IU. Good defense that time by the Cardinals.
They did do a good job. They kept Indiana away. Indiana had a couple of shots on the outside. They passed up.
I said John Hopgood. It's Brian Hopgood in the game. Now here's a pass in the corner to Bailey for a 3. No good. Rebound batted out. Battle 4 and picked off by Morton. He drives it left. Pulls up, fires, and missed it. Rebound inside goes to Miner, who misses the jumper. And finally, Matt Nover clears it out for IU. Down the floor to Graham. Greg takes it in the lane, gives to Calvert Cheney. He stepped out of bounds. So that's Indiana's 10th turnover. And the ball will belong to Louisville once again. Here's Brian Evans coming over, and apparently he's either shaken up or he lost the contact leg, so or maybe a cut. He's got a cut. We may see just a thumb dislocation of some kind. I don't know.
I think that's the problem. Boy, that could really hurt. I think it's a thumb problem. It looks like it. Dr. Bombadook working on it.
Alan Henderson comes in to replace Brian Evans. So Louisville on the attack. They trail by 8. Legree with it. Left side to Troy Smith. Cross-court pass comes off to Miner. Down low to Rozier. Rozier spins on Nover. Lane slams it in. That's the 8th point for Rozier. He got 3 for an easy slam jam. 6-point lead for IU as Bailey brings it across the timeline. Drives it baseline. Pulls up. Puts it up. Go! No, it wouldn't go. Rebound tapped up. Battle Henderson back up and couldn't get it. Rebound again. Battle 4 and Morton's got it for Louisville. 2-on-1 break. Morton to Legree. He lays it up. Block shot by Graham, and he can't save it. What a play by Greg Graham. Terrific defense on what looked like might be a sure tour, or at least a foul. But Graham had a tremendous block, and it'll be minor inbounding for the Cardinals. He gets it back to Dwayne Morton. Morton drives inside, fires it up. No good. Manton over with a rebound. Outlet to Calvert Cheney. Calvert slows. A three on the way. No good. The rebound comes back outside to Louisville. Here's Rozier to Legree. Legree on the right wing. Down low it comes to Smith. Outside pass to Rozier. Now off to Morton. Morton goes to Miner on the left wing. Miner holds. Gets it back out to Smith. Smith looks it inside. Lobs it low to Morton. Morton drives, turns around. Fires the shot up and no good. Rebound Alan Henderson. Henderson goes to Damon Bailey. Bailey now. Top of the key. Left side to Greg Graham. Graham looks low. Can't find Calvert. Brings it back out to Damon. Indiana needs to set the offense and get a good shot this time. Here's Calvert. Bob Knight wanting a difference here. Here is Calvert now going right. Goes to Bailey. He drives. Kicks it out to Cheney. Cheney, a 16-foot jump shot. Gone! Calvert Cheney, his first two of the second half, is 16th point, and Indiana's lead is back up to 8. 54-46. Legree across the timeline. Backcourt directs traffic. Greg Graham guarding him. Legree now left side pass to Troy Smith. Smith looks in, gets it back out to Rozier. Rozier goes right side to Legree, back to Dwayne Morton. He fakes, drives it left, spins, fakes, fires it up, and got it this time. Dwayne Morton has got his 10th point. 54-46. Indiana on top by only 6, however, as Greg Graham brings it across the timeline. Graham looks to left. Greg on the dribble, slowly in backcourt, waiting for somebody to break free, backs it out. Graham now starts it right again, moves it, goes left past the pick, pulls up, gets batted away. Graham retrieves it. Greg now back in the dribble. Drives it to the right, stops, looks, bounces to Madden over. Nover into Calvert. Calvert fakes, lost the handle, got it back out to Damon. Bailey down low to Nover. Nover drives it across the key, lost the handle, got it back to Bailey. Bailey inside, puts it out to Calvert for Greg Graham for a three. No good. Rebound. Pulled out of there by Morton, and suddenly the Hoosiers have drawn a cold spell. Here's Rozier, right side, puts it up and got it. Clifford Rozier has got his 10th point, and it's a four-point ball game, 54-50. 14:40 on the clock. Bob Knight wants the offense to start working properly. Here's Graham in backcourt. Graham looks, turns, gets it to Nover. Matt down low, kicks it to Bailey. Damon looks inside, can't find anybody. Bailey brings it back out, resets the offense. Damon looks right, now left, spins, drives on Miner, gets it off in the corner to Calvert. Cheney looks inside. 12 seconds on the shot clock to Graham. Greg drives, gives to Bailey. Three on the way. No good. Rebound Cheney. Tip up. Good! Calvert Cheney with a huge tip in. His 18th point. Here's Morton the other way. 56-50, Indiana lead. Here's Rozier down low. Pitches back out to Legree. A 22-footer. No good. Batted up. Calvert Cheney's got the rebound. Cheney gives to Bailey. The Hoosiers on the attack again. Bailey takes it all the way inside, pulls up underneath, and tried to hand it off. A battle for it out of bounds, and it belonged to Louisville. We got timeout call. Score, Indiana 56, Louisville 50. The Hoosiers can't pull away from the Cardinals. We'll be back after the 60-second network break.
If your car does this, pick up the nearest phone and do this. That's 1-800-LET-NAPA. It's your direct line to the location of the nearest NAPA store. That's where you get high-quality parts, plus the advice you need from the NAPA professionals. So when you need to hear this, just remember to do this. 1-800-LET-NAPA. NAPA, because there are no unimportant parts.
In the Hoosier State, State Farm is there, keeping in touch with Indiana families. When you have an insurance claim, you want the coverage to be there. That's why State Farm agents are there with a free family insurance checkup, keeping in touch, to help keep you protected. Auto, home, life, and health, wherever you live, from Merrillville to Madison.
And like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Well, back once again at St. Louis Arena, where the Hoosiers are leading Louisville 56-50. We have 13 minutes, 38 seconds to go in this ballgame.
Well, Don, Indiana hit so well in that first half, better than 70%, but had just a scant 7-point lead. You knew they couldn't keep up that kind of a percentage. This half, it's just 5 of 11 right now. That's 3-point shooting, 5 of 11, as they've gone 0 for 5. Shooting-wise, they're 2 for 9, just 22% in this half. So they have really had a tough time out there. The only thing that's really helping them is Louisville is not a great deal better, as they've hit just 3 out of 11 in this second half for just 27%. Neither team has done well 3-point shooting. The Louisville Cardinals have not even put one up here in this second half. Free throws, the Cardinals now beginning to miss a few of those after hitting 7 straight in that first half of play. So Indiana struggling right now with its shooting.
Well, they were certainly due for that kind of a spell. Brian Evans on the sidelines has a sprained thumb, and they've got it taped up, and whether he'll be back or not, we'll have to wait and see. Cardinal basketball. James Brewer has come in the ball game to replace Keith Legree for the Cardinals. Brewer across the timeline, bounces to Troy Smith, left wing. Smith holds, goes down to the corner, long bound by Miner, got it again. Greg Miner is perfect tonight for 3-point range, 4 for 4. He's got 12. It's a 1-point, make it a 3-point ball game now, 56-53. Here's Bailey to Calvert. Chaney looks low, gets it to Nover. Matt turns around, back to Calvert. Chaney now looks inside, drives it right, gives it off to Matt Nover. Baseline move, a whistle. He stepped on the line. So IU turns it over for the 12th time. Indiana is really struggling here in the second half. They got it going quite early, and then all of a sudden it's faded. Here comes Brewer across the timeline. Bats, oh, almost lost it. Troy Smith comes up with it. Outside it goes to Rozier. He drives on Nover. Pulls up inside, pushes it up, no, and an offensive foul. Rozier gets nailed in an offensive foul, his first foul of the ball game. He just put his shoulder down and tried to drive inside. Here comes Pat Graham in for IU. So Pat Graham checks in. To the sideline goes Alan Henderson. Pat Graham has checked in for Allen. Here comes Greg Graham across the timeline. Greg, left side to Pat Graham on the wing. He's guarded by Rozier, out to Bailey. Damon fakes, gives it back to Greg Graham. He fakes, he drives, gives it to Pat Graham. He fakes, he fires the jump shot and missed it short. Rebound comes away to Greg Miner. Back down the floor, Louisville. The Cardinals are down by just 3. It's their chance here. Webb is in for Louisville. Here's Rozier in the baseline. Tries to work on Calvert. Pulls up, fires, and missed it. And the rebound to Matt Nover. Nover pulls it out of there, gives it to Pat Graham. Graham looks at right side, comes out to Bailey. Damon drives it left on the wing, stops and gives it to Calvert. Calvert jumps it into Nover, turns, puts it up and in. Matt Nover's got 13. Indiana by a 58-53 count. Here comes Brewer for Louisville. Dwayne Morton getting set to check back in for the Cardinals. Brewer goes left to Troy Smith. Smith on the wing, outside pass to Rozier, inside, nice feed to Brewer for the easy layup. They had a backdoor play, and Brewer converted for his 12th point. Now it's 58-55. Up the floor, Greg Graham for IU. Here's the pass left in the corner to Calvert Chaney. Calvert drives, 10-foot jump shot, got it. Calvert Chaney's got 20. He starts to find the range again. 58-60-55 now is the score. I got quit looking at that one end zone. The problem is it's easier to look at that one than it is the one above us. Here's the bouncer to Miner, right side to Smith on the wing. Smith holds, lobs it into Rozier, turns, puts it up, and got it. Clifford Rozier down low is very tough to stop, and he's got 12. 60-57. The Hoosiers' lead is 3. Greg Graham to Calvert Chaney. Calvert on the wing, on the dribble. Outside pass to Pat Graham. Pat off to Greg Graham on the wing. Greg holds, looks it inside. Greg can't find anybody, goes to Calvert. Chaney, top of the key to Damon Bailey. Bailey looking low, having trouble. Finds Pat Graham outside. Pat brings it back to Damon. Louisville playing a lot more intense defense, it looks like. Here's the pass to Pat Graham. Right side pass to Nover. Knocked out of bounds. Indiana ball. And we got time. Score. 60-57. Indiana leading Louisville. We have 10:26 to go. Back after the 60-second network timeout.
The Hoosier Lottery reminds basketball fans that you have to play to win.
Well, with 2 seconds left, the All-Stars are going to have to get the ball to star shooter Swish Sampson. Dave the Dribbler, Nelson Edbounds looking for Swish, but where is he? Oh, no, the Swishers on the sideline signing autographs. The All-Stars lose a heartbreaker all because of a 7-foot ego trip.
Get in the game and win. Play the Hoosier Lottery.
Go Hoosiers. Play Lotto Cash this Saturday for $3 million. All cash, all at once. The Lotto Cash jackpot is $3 million, but you got to play to win.
Say, neighbors, that one of those new snapper lawn tracks.
Power, a Briggs IC with 12 horses, Peerless 5-speed gear drive, 30-inch cutting deck with 6 cutting heights, 32-inch turning radius, 2-year limited warranty.
Boy, you must have run into some cash to buy this snapper tractor a couple of months before the grass needs to be cut.
Oh, not at all. I just use Snap Credit, so I don't have to start paying for it until October. Besides, with snapper tractors starting at $14.99, these babies aren't going to last very long down at the snapper dealer.
You know, neighbor, I think I'll go visit that snapper dealer before the spring rush starts.
Serena Donfisher and Max Sterling bringing you the play-by-play story with Indiana on top right now, 60-57 over Louisville. You know, most people are familiar with the NCAA through its basketball tournaments, but the quest for national titles isn't limited to March Madness. During the 1992-93 academic year, the NCAA will administer 79 championships in 21 sports. More than 21,000 men and women student athletes will compete in these events for national titles, a message from the NCAA.
Well, Indiana was really cold to start the second half. They missed the first 3 shots they took. Then they hit only 1 out of their first 8, 2 out of their first 10. They finally got it up to 4 out of 12 now. Louisville, on the other hand, is hitting 6 of 15 in this half. Indiana's shooting now down to 60% after a 74% first half. Louisville shooting 46% for the game. And the rebounding, it's a 20-20 right now. Both teams are even, but Louisville has 8 offensive rebounds compared to only 3 for Indiana.
Indiana will have a basketball with a 3-point lead as Damon Bailey will inbound. Bailey, Pat Graham, Greg Graham, Calvert Cheney, Madden over the lineup for IU. James Brewer along with Greg Miner, Dwayne Morton, Clifford Rozier, and Derwin Webb the lineup for Louisville. The inbound will come Bailey. Backcourt to Madden over. Nover turns around, looks for help, finally clears to Calvert. Cheney has it now as he slides it left, goes back right, pulls up, fires the jump shot, and missed the shot badly. Derwin Webb was the guy he ran into, but no call either way. Here is Morton now, who turns, and he traveled but got away with it. Back outside pass comes finally to James Brewer. Indiana by 3, 60-57. Here's Rozier, cross-courts it off to Miner, who drives, pulls up, fires it right. Brewer with a 3-point try, no good. Rebound comes off to Indiana's Calvert Cheney. Cheney clears to Bailey. Bailey up court to Greg Graham. The Hoosiers with the offensive charge once again. Now, here's Bailey. IU fans starting to come back into the ball game, trying to get this ball club going offensively. Here's Calvert down low, turns on Miner, spins, fakes. Lost it into Graham, puts it up and got it. Greg Graham scores his 20th point of the ball game. A big bucket there for IU. The lead goes up to 5. 62-57. Here in the backcourt is Greg Miner. Left side to Dwayne Morton. Morton holds high. Outside to Rozier. Rozier goes to Miner. Miner, back out it comes to Morton. Morton, left side to Brewer. Brewer looks inside, goes to Rozier on the baseline. He looks against Nover, spins on him, turns, looks, fires it up and got it. Clifford Rozier has got 14. He's been working tough down low. 62-59. Indiana leads by 3. Here's Pat Graham in backcourt. Circles right. Pat drives it to the wing. Pulls up, looks for help. Bounces it out to Greg Graham. Graham against Derwin Webb, stops his move, looks at left, having trouble, finally gets it out to Calvert. Cheney turns, fires up an 18-footer, got it! A 3! They say it's a 3, and Calvert's got his 23rd point of the ball game. That's his second 3, and the Hoosiers suddenly lead it 65-59. Brewer the other way, stripped away but a foul. Greg Graham will get nailed on it. That'll be Graham's second personal. So Greg now has 2. James Brewer was the guy he hammered. It's 65-59, and Greg Graham, or rather James Brewer, will go to the line. Brewer, as we said earlier, very good free throw shooter, 88% of the season, and 2-for-2 in this ball game. He's got 12. Brewer at the line for two. Eyes for the first attempt. Up it goes, and it is no good. He doesn't miss many. So far in this half, 1-of-5 for Louisville. So the Cardinals have really struggled after having a great first half of play in the free throw shooting department. Todd Leary checks in. They were 7-for-7 in the first half. Greg Graham sits down. So Graham is down. Leary is in at the free throw line. Brewer for one more. Tries to cut Indiana's 6-point lead to 5, and this one drops. 13 now for Brewer. Indiana's Pat Graham will bring it up. Gets it to Bailey, and Damon now across the timeline in backcourt. Damon starts it to the right. Damon to the wing. Lobs it down low to Calvert. He turns. Cross-courts to Todd Leary. Leary fakes. Can't get the shot away. Comes out to Bailey. Bailey now top of the lane. Circles again right. Stops. Looks left. Bounces to Pat Graham. Pat turns around to Nover. Nover down low against Morton. Up and in. Matt Nover, his 15th point. What a good move inside on Morton. He had a mismatch size-wise, and that was a big bucket. Indiana by 7. 67-60. Here's Brewer to Morton. Morton on the left wing holds high. Comes outside to Miner. Greg Miner smooths back left. Goes to Morton again. Morton back again to Miner. Miner directs traffic and now dribbles to his right. Gives the ball to Brewer, who goes to Derwin Webb right wing. Webb back into Troy Smith. Smith down low. Rose, or rather Morton, fires it up and got it. Nice play by Dwayne Morton for his 12th point. 67-62. Here comes Indiana's Todd Leary. Leary across the timeline. Todd spins in backcourt, tries to move it right, comes back left, stops, fakes the pass, now looks and finds Calvert Chaney. Chaney, one dribble to Damon Bailey. Bailey circles it back to the right side. Looks down low, lobs it inside to Calvert. Baseline move on Miner, turnaround fadeaway jump shot. Good! Calvert Chaney's 25th point. What a shot that was. 69-62, IU by 7 again. Outside to Brewer. James Brewer, backcourt on the hold, looks inside, gives it off to Miner. He goes right side to Webb on the wing. Back out it comes to Morton. Morton drives on Leary to the baseline. Cut off by Damon Bailey. Fires the jumper off the rim, no good. Rebound, Pat Graham. Graham gives to Bailey. Back off to Pat Graham across the timeline. Here's Pat Graham, pulls up at the 15-foot line. Inside pass to Calvert, shot up and in! 27 for Chaney in Indiana with its biggest second half lead of 9. 71-62. We have 6:15 to go. Now, Brewer passes the ball. It comes away to Miner. Back to Brewer. Brewer starts it left. Bounce pass to Morton. Morton holds on the wing. Back out to Troy Smith. Right side pass to Brewer. Brewer lets a three-pointer fly. It's off the rim. No, rebound over. Indiana basketball, and Damon Bailey will bring it down. Bailey quickly across the timeline, slows it, looks right side. Still on the dribble. Damon brings it outside to Todd Leary. Leary, he holds. He moves it to the right. He gets it off to Bailey on the wing. He drives it to the free throw line in the lane. Jump pass goes to Calvert. He fakes the three, drives it inside, fires the shot up, and got it! Chaney, his 29th point of the ball game. Indiana leads 73-62, their biggest lead of the contest. Timeout, Louisville! The Hoosiers have got an 11-point lead. We have 5 minutes and 25 seconds to go. We'll be back after this 60-second network timeout.
Now, Madam Yolanda will read your palm. Oh, you're a farmer. You grow beans.
Soybeans.
I feel a powerful presence. Two strong forces working together to solve all your problems.
Could it be Tricept herbicide?
Are your problems broadleaf weeds and grasses?
Yes.
Like pigweeds, foxtails, cockleburr?
Yeah.
Ah, then the answer is Tricept, made with Scepter herbicide and Triflan herbicide for the most power you can pack in a jug.
All that's in my palm?
No, in your Tricept brochure. Oh, one more thing. See your Cyanamid AgriCenter dealer. Read and follow label directions.
Hi, this is Willard Scott for True Value. We'd like to recognize the Indiana University basketball team, better known as the Hoosiers, for their hard work all season. A basketball team and household cleaners have a lot in common. They both want to sweep up their opponents. But the advantage household cleaners have is that they can use an 18-inch Palmyra push broom from Empire to handle tough cleanups. It has a durable hardwood handle and is just $4.97 at your local True Value hardware store or home center.
Before we go any further, let's pause 10 seconds for station identification. This is the Indiana University Basketball Network.
WNJY Joy 103, where Bob Worthington takes your request on Solid Gold Saturday night. It's at 7 o'clock every Saturday night here on Joy 103.
Well, back once again where Indiana has taken their biggest lead of this ball game, 73-62 over the Louisville Cardinals. We have 5:25 remaining.
Well, Don, this is an old score. I forgot to give it a moment ago in the excitement of this game. Western Kentucky was leading Florida State 63-62 with 6.5 minutes to go. That game probably is nearly over by now. Well, Indiana has hit 6 shots in a row. They've outscored them 6-0 in the last 2 minutes of play. They've outscored them 8-3 over the last 3 minutes of play, and they have their largest lead now at 11. That's the largest lead of the game, as Cheney is having a sensational second half. He's missed only 2 shots out of a possible 9 that he's taken, so he is 7 of 9 this half.
Damon Bailey will take a brief rest. Gray Graham is back in there with Pat Graham, Calvert Cheney, Mandover, and Todd Leary. Louisville on the floor with Greg Miner inbounding to Keith Legree, who's checked back in for James Brewer. Now to Troy Smith, left wing. Smith holds, kicks it out to Rozier, top of the key, right side pass to Legree. Legree back outside, long bomb by Miner, a three-pointer this time is no good. His first miss from that range, and the kick out comes to Pat Graham. Graham clears away to Leary. Leary across the timeline. Todd slows it in backcourt, and Indiana's going to work some clock. Now, Leary moves it left. Stops, goes to the wing to Pat Graham. Back to Todd. Now up to Gray Graham. Graham back out to Todd. Now in the Pat Graham corner. Back out it comes to Leary. Leary pulls up, goes to Gray Graham. He fakes the three. Comes back outside to Todd Leary. Zone being used now by Louisville. Three-pointer by Pat Graham. Off the rim, no. Rebound comes off to Keith Legree. So, Louisville with the basketball back, trailing by 11. Legree goes right side to Miner, down low. It comes to Smith, back to Miner. Another three on the way, and this one is good. Miner has hit 5 out of 6 from three-point range. That's his 15th point of the ball game. He has been something. 73-65. 4:19 to go. Here is Todd Leary. Holds, gets backcourt to Gray Graham. Gray Graham now. Bob Knight's now having a couple of things changed offensively. We're playing a zone out here for Louisville. Here's Pat Graham. Pat Graham now slides it back out to Todd Leary. Boxing one, are we seeing? Here's Gray Graham. Graham now holding on the left side of the circle. Back to Leary. Drives it right side. Gives to Pat Graham. Pat inside pass to Nover. Matt fakes inside. Puts it back to Todd Leary. He fires the bomb. Got it! Todd Leary bangs home a huge three-point bucket. And the lead's back to 11 at 76-65. Now across the timeline, Legree. He goes left wing. The pass to Smith, outside to Rozier. Off to Legree on the right side of the circle. Back out it comes to Morton. He drives on the left side, spins, fakes, fires, and missed the shot, and Calvert's got the rebound. Cheney getting a box and one. Defense used against him right now. Here comes Todd Leary across the timeline. The pass to Gray Graham in backcourt. 3:15 to go. Todd Leary to Gray Graham, right side. Back off to Todd Leary, left side. In the corner to Pat Graham. Inside to Nover. Back out to Todd. Now Todd holds, fakes the pass. Gives it back to Pat Graham in the corner left. Calvert has one man on him, and everybody else is in his zone. Gray Graham brings it back out. They're using clock. We're down to 14. Now, Gray looks in. 10 seconds. Now up to Todd Leary. 8 seconds on the shot clock. Here's Leary. Jump pass goes to Gray Graham. He fakes. He drives. He fires a long bomb. It's off the glass. No. And the rebound to Troy Smith. Shot clock almost went on. 76-65. Here is Miner. Backcourt pass goes to Legree. Legree looks in. Comes back to Miner with a throw. Miner has it knocked away by Pat Graham. Out of bounds. It'll belong to Louisville. And we're going to have another timeout. 2:27 to go. Time is called. The score is Indiana 76, Louisville 65. We'll be back after the 60-second break. This is the Indiana University Basketball Network.
Logan Sport Ford Lincoln Mercury, the affordability store, has the number one best-selling car in America. Plus, they have the number one best-selling truck in America. At Logan Sport Ford Lincoln Mercury has great selection, a pleasant atmosphere, affordable quality service, and guaranteed no high pressure. Their goal at Logan Sport Ford Lincoln Mercury is your total satisfaction. Nobody makes it more affordable than the Logan Sport Ford Lincoln Mercury store, located at the east end of the Logan Sport Mall.
McGreevy's Pizza King, a place where your lunch hour is your time. Come in, sit down and relax. Choose from a large selection of super sandwiches, delicious salads, and sensational soups. Let them bring the food to you. McGreevy's Pizza King wants you to enjoy your lunch hour. For your next lunch break, enjoy McGreevy's Pizza King on the square in Delphi. McGreevy's Pizza King, more than just great pizza.
Here at St. Louis Arena, Don Fisher and Max Skirvin, Indiana leading it. Right now, by a count of 76-65, we're down to 2 minutes and 27 seconds to go in the basketball game. And Max, this has been a whale of a contest.
It has, Don. We anticipated just what we're seeing here. Well, you sometimes live by the three and sometimes you die by the three. Louisville right now is in the process of dying, hitting only 2 out of 6 three-point shots in this half. They're now 8 of 17 for the game. They were really pretty good in the first half, 6 of 11, but they've struggled here in this second half. On the other hand, Indiana is not hitting three-point shots either very well, 2 of 8, but certainly Todd Leary hit a big one a while ago. After Indiana had run off 6 straight, Louisville came down with a 3 to cut it to 8. Leary came right back and matched it. For the game now, Indiana continuing to shoot well, 62%. This half, they're 52%. Louisville, on the other hand, is hitting just 39% in this half. That's largely due to the fact they're shooting so many three-point shots.
Overtime with Florida State and Western Kentucky, and they're down to 3 minutes to go, and Florida State has a two-point lead in that overtime. Indiana on defense. Inbound from Miner to Legree. Legree in backcourt, right side to Derwin Webb. Webb on the wing. He holds. He looks. He fires it outside to Morton. He fires a three-point shot off the rim, no. Rebound, Troy Smith. Back up he goes and got it. Troy Smith with a two-pointer. He's got his 8th point of the game. Up the court. Greg Graham with a basketball to Pat Graham. Pat against the double-team trap. Fires it away to Greg Graham. He'll try to cross the timeline and does, and we got a foul. So Greg Graham will go to the line. He was fouled on the play.
Number 44.
Well, wait a second. Derwin Webb checks back out. Out goes Troy Smith. Rozier comes back in. So does James Brewer. And that, of course, it was a foul before the shot, and they're not in the 1-1 yet. Here's Pat Graham, and almost lost it. Got it back, fights it, and gets it to Todd Leary, and that's an over and back. Bob Knight says no. Bob Knight says absolutely not.
I don't think it ever. He's Knight saying it never ever had gone across the line yet.
And Knight's got the officials talking to one another about it. Let's see.
They're going to give it to him.
They're not going to give it to IU. It's going to be Louisville's ball. Here's the pass into Brewer. It is a 9-point ball game. 1:52 left. Here's Miner outside to Brewer. A 3 on the way. No good short. Rebound long. It comes to Calvert Cheney's foul. Brewer will be called for the personal. That will be his 2nd of the ball game. So Louisville can't convert, and the Hoosiers get the ball back. A couple more seconds come off the clock. We're down to 1:45 remaining.
That's 14 fouls on both teams, Don.
So we're still not in foul territory for the shooting type situation, and Morton is called for another one as he tries to steal. I don't know why you want to just give away fouls. You really want to take a good shot at stealing the basketball, and Morton really just fouled him there. So Indiana will take it out again. Calvert Cheney will inbound. He looks and having trouble. He calls timeout. Time is called for Indiana. So Calvert was having trouble finding somebody to throw it in. The Hoosiers lead 76-67 with the basketball with a minute 43 seconds to go in this contest.
Well, Indiana nursing that lead and time starting to run out. Indiana has, however, got to protect the basketball, and then they've got to take advantage of it. Louisville in a tough position right now. They've got to have with a 9-point lead, they've got to have at least three trips down the court and 3 points each just to tie. So Indiana certainly at the moment in the driver's seat. Matt Nover has been the iron man of this game. He has been in there for the entire 40 minutes, I believe. He's been in there all 20 in the first half. I don't recall him going out, but Coach Knight has now taken him out because obviously Matt has had some problems shooting free throws on occasions. Coach Knight, I'm sure, feels Indiana's going to be at the line very shortly, although there are just 5 fouls called on Louisville right now, putting in some ball handlers to see what he can do. Rebounding this half, Don, interestingly enough, Indiana out-rebounding Louisville by a 15-13 margin, with Cheney with 5 and Matt Nover with 4 for the game. Indiana's up 26-24. I'd have to find that as a surprising statistic, but I think that just shows you what kind of a quality ball club Indiana can be. They have 2 people sitting on the bench right now. Brian Evans with a finger, with a thumb that's sprained. And of course, we all know Henderson's got problems. He did play 7 minutes in the first half and has played some here in the second half, but you can't expect him to play a lot. So they're doing it with some iron work out there right now.
Indiana's bringing in all their best free throw shooters now. Matt Nover's coming out of the ball game. That means that Todd Leary will be in there with Bailey, Greg Graham, Calvert Cheney, and Pat Graham. So a very short lineup in for the Hoosiers, but it's their best shooting lineup by far. However, you can hardly say anything negative about Matt Nover tonight. Boy, that guy is something. He has been a phenomenal basketball player this season compared to his first 4 years at IU.
He's been called a blue-collar worker. He certainly has done that tonight.
Damon Bailey will inbound for IU. You can bet Louisville's not going to let too much time fly off the clock. Team fouls now are at 5 for Louisville, but they can still give up 2 before the 1-1. Here's the inbound of Pat Graham to Todd Leary. Backcourt, he drives it down the floor. Todd across the timeline, and he is hammered. Keith Legree is the guy who got him. Legree's second personal foul, and Todd Leary, who did not miss a free throw during the entire Big Ten portion of the season, is hoping to get a chance at some point, but it won't be until the next one's committed. Damon Bailey inbounds to Greg Graham. The Hoosiers now can work clock. Here's Graham giving to Cheney. Calvert back to Greg. Greg outside to Pat Graham. Pat now is fouled. And it'll be a foul on Greg Miner. That will be his 3rd of the ball game. Miner picked up 2 very quickly in the first half, and Maxey stayed foul-free until that one right there with 1:27 to go.
Okay, it's going to be Pat Graham going to the line, and Pat has got to make these things because, you know, and Coach Knight's still arguing with the official over there. I wouldn't call it an argument, but I think he's questioning his judgment on that over and back call a while ago.
Pat Graham is at the stripe. The first one in the air is no good, and the rebound comes away to Miner. Down the floor comes Louisville. They're down 9. A 3 would put them within 6. Here is Martin outside to Legree. Legree now dribbles against Graham, gets it out to Morton, lost the handle, picks it up, drives it left side, pulls up for a long bomb, and no good. Rebound inside, batted out of bounds, Indiana ball. Indiana will have it. Here comes Damon Bailey in the lineup, and out goes Matt Nover once again. So the Hoosiers take the opportunity to substitute their best free throw shooters. Although Pat Graham didn't make it look too good there. Here's Bailey looking to inbound, gets it into Greg Graham, and he'll bring it up the floor. Greg looks, fires it off to Damon Bailey. Bailey now bounces to Todd Leary. Leary is fouled this time by Miner, and he'll go to the line. So Miner picks up number 4, and one of their best three-point shooters now. Max can't afford another one, or he'll be gone with 1:01 left.
Well, I suppose if you want to foul somebody, Indiana would prefer to have Todd Leary as much as any. He is 30 for 32 this season. Has missed only 2. They both came before the Big Ten season started.
Todd Leary will go to the line. This guy has been some kind of player for this Hoosier ball club off the bench. He fires the free one. It is no good. He missed it. Indiana's missed 2 straight. Here's Louisville. They're still down 9, however. We're inside 55. Legree with the ball outside to Brewer. Brewer backs it out, fakes the 3, then pulls it out to Dwayne Morton. Morton now drives it left. He fires the 3. It's way off the mark. The rebound kicked outside, and it's going to be over and back. Yes, it is. Over and back the call, and Indiana will have it. Todd Leary threw the ball up behind his back. It went in. And of course, does not count.
So Bailey now will inbound as he comes back in for Nover. Bob Knight saying, come on, guys, start hitting the free ones. Here's Calvert Cheney, and he's fouled by Brewer. So Brewer picks up the personal. That will be his third of the ball game, and Calvert Cheney will now try his luck. Calvert, in the first half, was 7 out of 8 from the line. He's not been at the stripe in this half, but he's got 29 points, and he has scored 15 of those in the second half of play.
Well, he came into this game averaging 26 points in his first two games, so he had 29 points. It's not going to hurt his average at all. He was 11 for 15 in the first two games up at Indianapolis last weekend.
38 seconds remain. Calvert Cheney to the line, looking for his 30th point of the game. Another 1-1. The Hoosiers have missed their last two 1-1 tries. Calvert doesn't. He cans his 30th point of the contest. He'll have one more shot coming. And Indiana now leads it by 10 at 77-67. The Hoosiers can start breathing a bit easier with 38 seconds to go. Cheney fires the second and rimmed out. Rebound comes off to Louisville. Down the floor, Greg Miner. Miner fakes the three, fires to Morton. Back out to Miner. Miner fires the three, and no good. Rebound tipped up. Rozier inside, puts it up and scores. Rozier's got 16. Inbound, Cheney goes to Pat Graham. Up the floor to Greg Graham, and Graham is fouled by James Brewer. Brewer will be called for the foul. That will be his fourth of the ball game. So now Greg Graham will go to the line. And will Indiana get two this time? I believe so. So Greg Graham goes to the stripe. Indiana makes one free throw of their last 1, 2, 3, 4 attempts. And, of course, the previous three were 1-1s. Greg Graham with two coming. The first is up and the first is in. Greg Graham now has made his 21st point of the game. He'll have one more shot coming. He can take the lead back up to 10 if he hits number two. He eyes, he flies, and he hits. Greg Graham's 22nd, the Hoosiers by 10 with 29-20 seconds to go. Here's Brewer, the other way, pulls up. Block shot by Graham to Calvert Cheney. Calvert takes it out of trouble, he's fouled. Dwayne Morton will be called for the personal. And Indiana's Calvert Cheney and Todd Leary start hugging out there on the floor. Calvert will go to the line. And this Hoosier squad is starting to feel that they've got the ball game in hand.
The Indiana fans are supremely confident now. They're all on their feet. Everybody that could find a ticket is here, of course.
Calvert with 30 points. As Bob Knight will send Pat Knight in with 13.6 seconds to go. And Chris Reynolds as well. Calvert Cheney at the line. Here comes Mike Casey, who is an Indiana native out of Pendleton, Indiana. He went to Pendleton Heights High School. The 6'7 senior will come in for the first time in the ball game, so he'll get to play against this Hoosier ball club for 13 seconds. Out goes Todd Leary. And to the stripe is Cheney once again. Calvert with 30 points in the ball game. Boy, has he played great basketball this season. And he continues to do so as he drills his 31st, looking for his 32nd. And Bob Knight patting Damon Bailey on the knee. This Hoosier ball club suddenly with smiles, and Cheney can them both, 32. Here comes Pat Knight in, Indiana's biggest lead of the ball game at 81-69. Here comes Calvert to the sideline to a standing ovation. Greg Miner inbounds to James Brewer. Brewer brings it up the floor. Down to 11, down to 10. He lost the ball, got it back, throws up the three. No good. Rebound, Chris Reynolds, and a foul. So Indiana will have Reynolds going to the stripe for IU as we're down to 5.6 seconds remaining.
Well, Jim Brewer has missed 5 3-point shots in the second half alone. He's missed 8 totally here as the Louisville Cardinals have only hit 2 out of 12 3-point shots here in the second half.
At the line will be Chris Reynolds, who has not scored in this ball game. A 61% free throw shooter on the season would like to put his name on the scoreboard tonight with a pair. The first is up and it is good. Reynolds rattles at home his first point of the ball game. Now it's 82-69. The Hoosiers' biggest lead at 13. He'll try to make it 14 right here. His second one is High off the rim, no. The rebound comes off to Rozier. Rozier will bring it down all the way himself. He traveled with it, throws up a three, and we're into the final game of the Midwest Regional. It is Indiana winning it, 82-69, here at St. Louis Arena in St. Louis, Missouri. It's on to the Midwest Regional title ball game on Saturday for this Indiana basketball team. Again, the final score is 82-69, Indiana. We'll be back to recap this contest in a moment. This is a network timeout.
Football players, the fans, and certainly the coaches expect IU to have a winning season. It takes 100% effort from everyone to make the season successful. Varsity Club members support this winning effort by their generous gifts to the scholarship fund for the football team and 17 other varsity sports. The athletic department receives no tax dollars to support the program. We pay the bills through the generosity of our fans. Help the Varsity Club have a winning season with your gift. With your 100% effort, along with the hard work of our players and coaches, how can we lose?
This NC...
Chevy's, Logan Sports' most popular nightclub, invites you to rock and roll to the greatest hits of the 50s and 60s every Thursday, Friday, and Saturday night. Yes, Chevy's friendly atmosphere, unbelievable lighting, and outstanding sound makes for a good time for everyone. Now at Chevy's on Sunday night, it's country western night. So pull on the boots, get out the hat, and plan to dance the two-step at Chevy's. Whether you're looking for a little bit of country or a little bit of rock and roll, Chevy's has it. Located inside Meyer's Sport Bowl East, 1/2 mile east of the Logan Sports Mall.
It's in Indiana.
Well, back at St. Louis Arena, where Indiana has won the opening game here tonight in this Midwest Regional Tournament, third round, 82-69 over the Cardinals of Louisville. Indiana now stands 31-3 for the season, but more importantly, they're into the championship of this regional on Saturday against the winner of Game 2 here tonight between Kansas and the California Bears. Let's look at the individual scoring in this ball game. First of all, for the Louisville Ball Club, they were led tonight by Clifford Rozier with 16 points. He really had a solid second half in which he peppered the nets for 10, getting a lot of them, and in fact all of them, down inside. 15 points for Greg Miner. Miner was sensational tonight with 5 3-point field goals. 15 points for Miner. 13 points for James Brewer, 12 for Dwayne Morton, held under his average by 4. Then it dropped off to 8 points for Troy Smith, 3 points for Dick Rogers, and 2 points for Keith LeGree. Brian Hopgood, Derwin Webb, and Mike Case did not score in this ball game for Louisville. So their top scorers again, Rozier with 16, Miner with 15, 13 for Brewer, and 12 for Morton. For Indiana, the Hoosiers were led, as usual, by Calvert Chaney and Greg Graham. Chaney fired in 32 tonight in another sensational performance, and at one point in the second half, he was simply unstoppable. Greg Graham had another great effort. He had 22 points in this ball game. And Matt Nover, he continues to play just super steady basketball as he popped home 15 in this contest. It dropped off from there down to 6 for Damon Bailey, 3 each for Pat Graham and Todd Leary, and 1 point for Chris Reynolds. Alan Henderson, Brian Evans, Pat Knight all played but did not score in this contest. So Indiana with 3 players in double figures, led by Chaney's 32, Graham's 22, and Nover's 15. We'll be back to take a look at the team statistics in a moment. First, let's pause for the 60-second timeout. This is the Indiana University Basketball Network.
McGreevy's Pizza King, a place where your lunch hour is your time. Come in, sit down and relax. Choose from a large selection of super sandwiches, delicious salads, and sensational soups. Let them bring the food to you. McGreevy's Pizza King wants you to enjoy your lunch hour. For your next lunch break, enjoy McGreevy's Pizza King on the square in Delphi. McGreevy's Pizza King, more than just great pizza.
A law firm that believes integrity comes first. O'Brien and Morrissey wants you to know about their law practice located at 1015 Bank One Building in Lafayette. You can talk to Thomas O'Brien or Michael Morrissey with your first consultation free. They can assist you in divorce, personal injury, real estate, wills, estates, drunk driving, and criminal cases. Meeting the legal needs of the people in our area, O'Brien and Morrissey. Call 317-742-9027.
And so we won't forget it. Before we go any further, let's pause 10 seconds for station identification. This is the Indiana University Basketball Network.
WNJY, Delphi, Monticello, where Charlie Tuna and Machine Gun Kelly are the zany hosts of Your Good Time Oldies magazine. That's every Friday night here on Joy 103.
We're back.
You got excited, are you, Don?
No, I was just kind of not paying attention, I guess. We have a final score of 82-69, Indiana on top of Louisville. Max, let's look at those team stats.
I must confess, I was daydreaming right along with you, Don, thinking about playing perhaps Kansas in the Saturday game. Let me give you a score here. First, Florida State has beaten Western Kentucky 81-78 in overtime. So two of Kentucky, the state of Kentucky's three schools, came out quickly tonight and are out of the tournament. Well, Indiana finishes the night shooting 62%. They had a sensational first half, 73.9 on 17 of 23. They couldn't quite maintain that average in the second half, hitting 11 of 22, but that was good enough for a 28 of 45, 62.2%. For Louisville, they finished the half shooting 15 of 30, 50%, but they hit only 11 of 33 in the second half for just 33% for a game total of 26 of 63, 41.2%. Part of that shooting downfall is due to the fact that they put up so many second half three-point shots. As a matter of fact, they put up a total of 14 of them and were able to hit on two of them, two out of 14 three-point shots in the second half. So that really did them in as far as the game, and certainly hurt their average a great deal as they finished the game just shooting 26 of 63, 41.2%. From three-point range overall, Indiana finishes 7 of 14. They were 5 of 6 in the first half, fell off to just 2 of 8 in the second half, while Louisville was 6 of 11, as we mentioned, in the first half, 2 of 14 in the second half, 8 of 25 for the game, 32%. From the free throw line, Indiana 19 of 25, and that's in keeping with their shooting percentage. In fact, is a little better. They were shooting 71% on the season, 71% in their first two games of the tourney. So tonight it's 19 of 25, 76. For Louisville, they finished 9 of 13 after a 7 for 7 first half. They were just 2 for 6 in the second half. There was one down side to Indiana's play. They turned it over 13 times compared to only 10 for Louisville. In fact, Louisville only turned it over two times in the second half. That, again, is largely because they were putting up a lot of shots from outside, and you really don't turn it over much when you're taking those kind of shots. The surprising statistic, at least to me, is that Indiana was even with Louisville in rebounding, 30 each. And interestingly enough, both halves were exactly the same. 11 rebounds for each team in the first half, 19 for each team in the second half. So both teams finished exactly the same. Well, individually tonight, Calvert Cheney, a great shooting night, 10 of 12 from the field. He was 3 of 3 in the first half. He was 7 of 9 in the second half. He was 2 of 4 on three-point shots. Alan Henderson was 0 for 1. Matt Nover was 7 for 9 from the field. He was 5 of 7 in the first half, 2 of 2 in the second half. Greg Graham finishes 7 of 11 tonight. He was 6 of 7 in the first half, but just 1 of 4 in the second half for his 7 of 11. Damon Bailey, an off night, 2 of 7. That's after he's been struggling. He'd hit only 4 out of 14 in the first two games, shooting just 28%. So he didn't help himself much tonight percentage-wise, just 2 of 7. Todd Leary, 1 of 2, and boy, did he hit a big three-pointer. Indiana was up by 11. Louisville had cut it by 3 with 4 minutes to go. It looked like they might be going to do something. He matched that three-pointer, and it gave Indiana that 11-point lead again.
Pat Graham finishes one of three, and nobody else even took a shot that played in this basketball game. For Louisville, Troy Smith, 3 of 4. Wayne Morton was held a 4 of 13 shooting, just 2 of 9 in the second half. Rozier finishes with an 8 of 14 shooting. Keith LeGreer was just 1 of 5. Greg Miner was 5 of 8. And James Brewer, who had that sensational second game at Indianapolis with 26 points, could connect on only 4 of 16. He missed a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 three-point shots out there as he was blazing away. He came into this game a 40% shooter on three-point shots, but tonight was not to be. Indiana wins it by 13, and that was their largest lead of the game. They only trailed in this game one time at 3-2. They came right back with a three-point shot to take it 5-3. There was one tie at 21 all. They led at the half by 7, 50-43. Louisville got it down one time to about 5, but they couldn't get it any closer as Indiana wins it 82-69.
Joe Smith points out that a key point in this ball game, and there were quite a few, but this one had to be also. It was 67-62 Indiana, just a 5-point advantage when Calvert hit three straight baskets to take the lead to 11 points. 73-62. From there, the closest Louisville got was 73-65 with 5:17 to play. And certainly another great win for Indiana. All kinds of big plays tonight from a lot of different people. Damon Bailey, of course, drilled a three at the half to give the Hoosiers a 7-point lead. That was a huge basket there with 1.9 seconds, an out-of-bound pass from Evans to Bailey, and he turns and just hammers the jumper. And, of course, as we said, Leary had a great three-point basket. Calvert's play in the second half was sensational once again. Another great win for Indiana, and they're on to the championship of the Midwest Regional on Saturday to take on the winner of Game 2 here tonight between Kansas and California. Well, tonight's game has been brought to you in part by Indiana Gas for efficiency, comfort, and a cleaner environment. Natural gas is your best energy value season after season. By your local Napa Auto Parts store, Napa because there are no unimportant parts. By your local Amoco Certicare Repair Centers. By the Hoosier Lottery, where you've got to play to win. By State Farm Insurance and the more than 500 State Farm agents throughout Indiana. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. By the real estate professionals of the 121 Century 21 offices in Indiana. By True Value Hardware. Got a tough job? You can do it with True Value Hardware stores. And by Squadron Herbicide for a higher level of soybean weed control. Our special thanks tonight to our studio producer, Gary Klein, to our statistician, Joe Smith. Now this is Don Fisher for Max Skirman inviting you to stay tuned next for the IU postgame show. We'll be rejoining you in just a couple of minutes. So long, everybody.
It's been Hurry and Hoosiers exciting basketball here on WNJY Joy 103. You'll want to stay tuned for the postgame with Don Fisher. It's all IU excitement, and it's all right here on Joy 103.
Chevy's, Logan Sports' most popular nightclub, invites you to rock and roll to the greatest hits of the 50s and 60s every Thursday, Friday, and Saturday night. Yes, Chevy's friendly atmosphere, unbelievable lighting, and outstanding sound makes for a good time for everyone. Now at Chevy's on Sunday night, it's country western night. So pull on the boots, get out the hat, and plan to dance the two-step at Chevy's. Whether you're looking for a little bit of country or a little bit of rock and roll, Chevy's has it. Located inside Meyer's Sport Bowl East, 1/2 mile east of the Logan Sport Mall.
Goody Sports Center is always bleeding red for the Indiana Hoosiers, and they'll bleed red for you too. Goody Sports Center, located in downtown Monticello, is your total sporting goods headquarters, even if your favorite colors aren't red and white. If it has anything to do with sports, Goody's has it. Whether it's shoes, sweats, jackets, or any kind of sports equipment, you can get it at Goody Sports Center. Goody's, located in the Shoppers Concourse, 103 South Main in downtown Monticello. Call 583-3009.
Professional interiors. What does that mean? Well, according to Funk and Wagnall, professional means skilled in a profession, art, or craft. Interior means pertaining to the inside. Now, what it doesn't mean is expensive. At Professional Interiors, you'll find the best prices on the best brands of carpet anywhere. So don't be surprised if you find that high-quality carpet that you saw elsewhere and thought you couldn't afford, priced so low that you'll wonder how the other guy sells any of it. Professional Interiors, 570 South Main Street in Monticello. The best carpet and better prices.
Beaver Dam Inn in Monticello is the place for exquisite prime rib and scrumptious seafood. Visit Beaver's now for their nightly dinner specials, exceptional service, and delicious homemade soups. While you're there, ask about their catering and private party services.
located just south of the Norway Dam. Everyone's eager to eat at Beaver's. Open Tuesday through Saturday. Call 583-8375. The Beaver Dam Inn.
Logansport Ford Lincoln Merkley, the affordability store, has the number one best-selling car in America. Plus, they have the number one best-selling truck in America. At Logansport Ford Lincoln Merkley has great selection, a pleasant atmosphere, affordable quality service, and guaranteed no high pressure. Their goal at Logansport Ford Lincoln Merkley is your total satisfaction. Nobody makes it more affordable than the Logansport Ford Lincoln Mercury store, located at the east end of the Logansport Mall.
Well, once again, this is Don Fisher and Max Kirby with the IU postgame show, a review of tonight's ball game in which Indiana wins over Louisville 82-69 to go on to the championship game of this Midwest Regional. As always, our guest in the postgame, Norm Ellenberger. Norm, just a terrific win tonight over a very, very fine basketball team.
And just sitting here thinking while you're waiting to come back on, and then there were eight, and we're one of them. So we had all the respect in the world for Louisville. You know, they went through their league after they finally got rolling in January. They went through their league and then into their tournament, and were playing as well as anybody, I think, in this Final 16. And with their size and everything, we're scared to death. But our kids, when you come right down to it and think about it, we've won 31 ball games now, and a lot of them been against really good basketball teams and really tough games, and I thought that really helped us in here today.
I don't think there's any question, and that first half shooting performance was simply sensational.
Well, that's Coach Knight's fault. He adjusted. We didn't work out much on, well, we did too. We did a little bit on Monday, but he kind of set the stage for the offensive adjustment that he wanted for the ball game. And then we practiced on a little Tuesday and Wednesday, and doggone if we didn't execute it on Thursday. So we got to give him credit for that.
Certainly a great first half shooting performance when you hit 70-some percent, but when you're only up 7 at halftime, you got to wonder kind of what you got to do.
Well, they're an offensive run and gun team with, and they're going to score. And we were over helping. You know, we put so much emphasis on not letting their big folks kill us down inside, where they get us in foul trouble and that business. So we kind of over helped a little bit, and we adjusted that. And then at halftime, that was one of the big adjustments that Coach made. And they got loose inside a little bit, but we cut down those threes some. And after the first part of the half, and it got down to where later on that was about the only way they could catch up with us, and that worked too.
Obviously, a terrific performance, as we said, in the first half. It looked like things started to stagnate just a little bit in the second half at the beginning of it. However, you got to expect that you can't continue to hit over 70% from the field.
Well, it was either stagnated or constipated. I couldn't tell. I know it didn't move. I don't know whatever happened. But, we finally got that thing figured out. When all of that was happening, finally Calvert says, well, my other player buddies aren't going to do it, and the coaches aren't smart enough to figure it out, so I'll just go do it by myself. And doggone if he didn't.
Boy, he sure did. We'll be back and talk more with Norm Ellenberger in a moment, but first let's pause for the 60-second timeout.
Future doctor and Indiana University student Tony Chin.
I think we all start out with a goal in our life, to achieve something. I want to be a doctor because I was brought up to believe that helping people was good. I hope that I can be able to have the opportunity to do that, to teach, to help serve, as well as to educate others.
Thanks to donors who give scholarships to Indiana University through the IU Foundation, our communities will have terrific doctors like Tony.
By having the scholarship, I was able to get a good education here at IU.
Good luck, Tony, from the Indiana University Foundation.
This is the sound of a car broken down on the side of the road. The driver is thumbing his way to the nearest Napa Auto Parts store. Too bad he didn't think about that sooner. You see, we carry over 125,000 different parts. So if anybody can help him get back on the road fast, it's Napa. Napa, because there are no unimportant parts.
Well, back once again in our post-game show, Norm Ellenberger, our guest. Norm, just a couple of thoughts. One, we thought there were several big baskets in the second half. To say the least, Damon Bailey's last basket of the first half was very, very, very important. It gave you a seven-point lead in the locker room. But the second half, you got big key plays from a number of people, not the least of which was Todd Leary with a major three.
You know, that this team that we're playing is a great momentum team down through the years, and with the kind of athletes that they have, you can't let them get rolling on you or they'll kill you. You know, against Oklahoma State in the second half, after Oklahoma State led the whole way and really good with really good leads, they ran off 9 straight points on them, and that was the ball game. Just today we had guys, you know, whether it was Damon kept their momentum at check with that shot at the end of the half, and that one that Larry's talking about, and Calvert, and I think Greg got one in there. Nober got a big one down along the line. Everybody just seemed to step up, and that's what I was talking about. That's that little bit of mental toughness in there, I think, really helped out.
Brian Evans came up lame in the second half with a thumb injury.
Well, Brian played 16 minutes and didn't score a basket, but you know, he rebounded and played some good defense inside, and then he comes over and he holds up his hand, and his thumb's pointing west, and it should be pointing north, and so he's got a dislocated thumb, and they taped that thing all up, and they're trying to find some x-ray facilities now to see what the damage is, and so he's got that baby all taped up, and it's on his right hand, and so I don't, you know, that's just have to wait and see what happens there, but we're running out of big guys.
Well, you are, Norm, and Henderson played 11 minutes tonight. He really got some good play out of him, I thought.
I thought Alan just stepped right up and played the best that he's played thus far, and he was a little better in practice day before yesterday. We didn't do much yesterday, and he was better even today. So, you know, hopefully it will continue that way. It looks like he's getting more and more confidence with that knee.
Well, with Evans getting hurt, I mean, he was just absolutely vital to you. Although Nover went 35 minutes, I guess, or 40 anyway. Well, they got him for 40, but you did take him out a little bit there at the end.
Yeah.
But he was really your Iron Man.
Yeah, this thing's going to, it all depends on Evans. It's going to come down. There's going to be a whole big bunch thrown right at Pat Graham, the way it looks. I mean, there's that possibility. You know, Pat will get in and battle with him, and while he's a midget by inside standards, he'll be ready. I'm sure that he can really help us out inside too.
Norm, one more question or one more comment. You ended up 30-30 rebounding, which I find just really outstanding.
Yeah, that really is. I think they were a rebound or two ahead of us in that first half, and when we caught up with them there late in the game when we had to have some big rebounds when they were trying to make their comeback. And that's, you know, that's a bunch of little old guys that play in good position. And that's Coach Knight has started coming into this tournament. He wanted to play really good position basketball, and that includes screening out and keeping guys off the boards. And we did a pretty good job today of that.
Certainly, this next ball game tonight is a very important one. It'll determine who you play on Saturday. You've played Kansas before. You've not seen California this year. Any preference there, Norm?
No, not really. The preference was to get there, so we're there. And I don't know. You know, Cal maybe is a team of destiny. We'll get on through this one. People aren't predicting that. They think Kansas is experienced and in the tournament and so forth. So I think it'll be a whale of a ball game. And I kind of look for Kansas to win.
Another couple of long days ahead.
Well, they aren't going to be longer than those last two. And you know, it's we were talking today that you go back. That's 31 wins, and we started. I don't know what year it was, but it's been a long season with that NIT on the front end of it. But our kids seem to be resting. I thought that we were fresher at the end of the ball game than Louisville was. You know, we were still pushing it down the court. I thought that we looked good. We looked good in that category, so we don't have any problems. The only tired people around here is the coaches and the radio announcers.
You really got some good action right at the end of the half out of your bench. That helped, I'm sure.
I think you're right, Max. I think we're in pretty good shape, and we won't do a heck of a lot tomorrow. We'll just get ready mentally.
Obviously, Norm, we congratulate you again. We look forward to at least one more ball game.
Well, we got that, and we get one more, and then we can go to the big, big show.
That's right. Norm Ellenberger, our guest on the post-game show, as the Hoosiers win it 82-69. We'll be back with some final thoughts right after we pause for the 60-second timeout.
Goody Sports Center is always bleeding red for the Indiana Hoosiers, and they'll bleed red for you too. Goody Sports Center, located in downtown Monticello, is your total sporting goods headquarters, even if your favorite colors aren't red and white. If it has anything to do with sports, Goody's has it. Whether it's shoes, sweats, jackets, or any kind of sports equipment, you can get it at Goody Sports Center. Goody's, located in the Shoppers Concourse, 103 South Main in downtown Monticello. Call 583-3009.
McGreevy's Pizza King, a place where your lunch hour is your time. Come in, sit down and relax. Choose from a large selection of super sandwiches, delicious salads, and sensational soups. Let them bring the food to you. McGreevy's Pizza King wants you to enjoy your lunch hour. For your next lunch break, enjoy McGreevy's Pizza King on the square in Delphi. McGreevy's Pizza King, more than just great pizza.
Well, for the final time tonight from St. Louis Arena in St. Louis, Missouri, it's Indiana winning it 82-69. A terrific basketball game and a terrific win for this Indiana ball club, who now stand 31-3 on the season. That's the most victories by an Indiana team since the 1976 squad won the national championship. That's the 87th victory for this Hoosier squad under the current four-year senior class. That is the best three-year mark ever by any Big Ten basketball team. The 86-6 record of the 74-75-76 Indiana teams is the only one that is even close to that. And of course, this particular ball club's percentage is not as good, but max 87 victories is something else. I also point out, 2,951 points now for this Hoosier squad. That's a new school record.
They're on a seven-game winning streak right now. They had an eight-game streak earlier and a 13-game winning streak early in the Big Ten season, but they've now won seven in a row, and they just need a couple of more to go. Indiana this evening with some great shooting, 74% in the first half, 50% in the second, 62% for the game, and they were dead even rebounding against this Louisville team with Cheney and Nover with eight rebounds each, and that was just a great, great effort on the part of this Hoosier team.
Well, Indiana now is out of the championship game of this Midwest Regional. A couple of more notes here from Joe Smith. It says Greg Graham. What the heck is that?
Now you can see I'll have a hard time reading his writing.
Oh, he's right. Okay, Greg Graham is right at his average of 22.3 points per game in the last nine games since Allen went out. Tonight he had 22, so obviously another outstanding performance for Greg. And shooting-wise, Saturday for the second straight regional title. Of course, Indiana won it last year in the West Regional out in Boise and Albuquerque, New Mexico. The last two times IU's won a regional semifinal game, they've advanced to the Final Four. That was 1987 and again in 1992. They hope to make it three out of three.
Well, they have just played very, very well, Don. I mean, I don't know when this thing is going to end. Hopefully it won't end for at least three more games, but whatever, this has been a really outstanding basketball team.
Fun city it has been, to say the least. Indiana, an 82-69 winner over Louisville. The Cardinals wrap up their season 22-9, and Indiana goes on at 31-3. Our broadcast on Saturday will take place at 5:35 with a Bob Knight pregame show. Indiana versus the winner of Game 2 here tonight between Kansas and California. We hope you'll join us over most of these same stations, starting at 5:35 on Saturday afternoon with the Bob Knight pregame show. Until then, for Max Sherman, this is Don Fisher. So long, everybody.